welcome you all. And so we will just get started. I'm just trying to send a file here. And once the file is there, it would be much easier for me to show you. But meanwhile, okay, no issues. Okay, so there will be two things today happening. So we have few new students, and so we will start with some basics for deep learning. So, and then we will start some basic NLP, okay? So today's class is not gonna be completely focused on NLP, okay? It would be kind of basic introduction, and then we will go and look for NLP as well, okay? Basic what NLP means. And my estimate is right now, whatever I have seen with our overall topics, it feels to me, if everything goes as planned, it should be over within 6 classes. NLP section, that's all I'm saying, okay? Projects are extra, and projects can only be done who have done neural networks. Okay, for other people, they have to wait till they finish neural networks. So we have two people, Kirtish and Manak, who have already finished neural networks with me. So these guys, once they are through with NLP, they will be able to do some language sequencing and text generation project with LSTMs, GRUs, and whatnot. Other guys will be shifted directly to neural network theory. Okay. Now here, I will tell you right now, there is nothing about neural network. Okay. Very, very honestly. Okay. You can look at the whole thing. There is nothing about neural network. Only thing I will teach you word to vec, which is kind of not mentioned, but I told Krishna that we will add this. So someday it will get changed and we will have word to vec as well here. Word-to-vec is very important, and word-to-vec is nothing, is just a neural network encoding of the words. But don't worry, I will teach it nevertheless, because that's very important. And neural networks usually work very good with word-to-vec compared to anything like TF-IDF or any distancing or LDA or any technique that you apply. For classical approaches, LDA or TF-IDF would have worked great. But with neural network, we require something better, and word-to-vec kind of solves that problem for us. So we will be covering word-to-vec. That would be an extra topic that we will definitely cover. My hope is in each day, so hopefully I will be able to take care of the introduction today. Each day we will try to figure out if in within 3 hours we will be able to take care of all of the topics. Even if doesn't, I am more than okay to conduct an extra class. Don't worry. Mostly projects will happen offline more or less. Means either on Tuesday night or something, because I am practically very much engaged in morning and afternoon sessions these days. So I cannot conduct an extra project session while in weekend. So that's how the scenario is going to happen. Okay. All right. So hopefully it has still not arrived. Okay. No problem. Okay. Okay. So let me ask you a question. Meanwhile, Reddy actually also needs to provide me with the writing pad. One sec. Okay, let's take it like this. I hope people are kind of familiar with the general terminology here. Let me check. Hey guys, can you hear me right now, or is it like the old message? Hello. Hello, am I audible?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Okay. So, okay. Let's start with some basic definitions first. Okay, what is the problem with machine learning which deep learning solves? People at least who have taken the course can talk about it, and rest can listen right now. What do you find is the major difference? Anything else? Yeah, kind of hand, like feature engineering, especially by humans, is not required. In a very simple terms, you can say that, and I think that would be very relevant here. So, okay, how is it beneficial? Can anyone talk about it? How is it beneficial that I don't have to do feature engineering? Okay. Anything else? Yes. Every problem, it differs. With neural network, I would be really surprised if we think like it is somehow low time consuming. By no definition, I have never seen neural networks really be, means only in the implementation, they can be really fast. They can work as fast as they can. But while training, it is a much, much bigger process. It takes actually much more time than any classical machine learning. So we cannot even, we should not even think like it will take less time. What Kirtish said is actually very correct. Every problem is different or fundamentally, okay? Now, here we will have to take a biological inspiration, okay? You do deal with a lot of different problems in day-to-day life and you adapt, okay? So the idea is you have some general learning mechanism within you. You have some base knowledge of the world, how things work, what is causality. So you just do not jump based on correlations. I think I might have talked about it. So what is the idea between correlation and causality? Correlation and causality. Do you understand these two terms? So correlation you might have heard in statistics. What is correlation? Let's just talk about correlation. Good. It's a linear relationship if you are dealing with Pearson correlation. Okay. What is causality or what is causal relation? Causing the other. Yeah. One is causing the other, right? Makes sense. Yeah, makes sense. So yeah, that's very true if you think very carefully about it. That is a very good definition if I really press on that one. That fundamentally, correlation is that mathematical correlation, how the dependency. So if one variable X is increasing, is the dependent variable Y, or it could be reverse, okay? But let's say Y is the dependent variable. X is the independent variable. So what is happening with Y? Does it get affected or not? That's a simple correlation, okay? But now correlations could be found in very weird ways, okay? So, okay, what is the weirdest correlation you can think right now? Which is not causation, but still people kind of like to show it. Any correlation in real life that you can find, but that's not the causation part. Ice cream too? Okay. Got it.
Another example, season and prices.
Season and prices. So is there no causal relationship at all?
Yes, there.
I am asking about example which correlation is very high, but there is no actual causality over there. I'm asking those examples.
Season, summer, the ice cream sells high.
Shark attacks increases.
So, to take correlation between shark and ice cream,
Yeah, that's not the case. That's the example. That's where basically machines basically underperform. Okay, finding correlation for machine is extremely, extremely easy in this world. It can do that mass as many times you want. But the problem is this causal model. Okay. Now, again, I'm not claiming that we have made some significant advancement in causality study. People have started doing it again. Causal is the inference, or what is causing, if you want to think causing, so causal inference. Okay, what is causing what? Basically that's the whole discussion here. Okay, now correlation is it looks very close to it, that yes, if X is changing, Y is changing, but that's not a guarantee that X would be causing it as well. Okay, in a lot of places yes, there is a direct causation as well, but not everywhere it is true. And that is where we have to be extremely, extremely careful. Now, let's say even neural networks immediately cannot solve the causality issue. It can work very well with the correlation part. Okay, fine. Okay, so the idea which basically Kirtish said is, basically if every time I'm giving a different problem, I should be able to adapt and learn. That is the idea. Not that I need to hand twist or kind of make new solutions every time. Basically, that's the idea. So it's like AI researchers. So basically, I was discussing with one of my friends. So he comes from the statistical background, more or less. So he was talking about certain terminologies and everything. And I was like, these are all fine, but more and more data wrangling you do, in very astute sense, you are moving away from artificial intelligence. It is more hand design to very perceive say, okay. If I had to do everything about the data and then basically I make an inference, or basically then I apply the exact correct tool, it's not much of artificial intelligence that we have really done here. Okay, it's mostly human intelligence or human inference has been put, and one system is just automating everything. That's all it is done. Now, the problem with such systems is they need to be changed too much when to adjust with some other system. That by definition becomes a narrow system, that all that processing makes sense for one set of data. So the idea is processing you will do for images might not have any significance in words. I'm not saying you should not try to understand the statistical nature of NLP or the images. It is important. While designing algorithms, it is very important. But if we just get focused by that point, then idea of having a general learning mechanism fails. And this is where neural networks have shown some way. Again, it's very good with pattern recognition. I'm not saying everything has been solved. But with pattern recognition, it is like, okay, you keep giving me the labeled data or even unlabeled in autoencoders and stuff. And I will be able to understand or approximate any function almost, whichever is ruling that distribution or whichever based on which you have generated your data. Now, that's the power of neural networks. And basically, this class mostly is about neural networks. You have to understand that even we are doing CV, NLP, but everything at the end points to neural networks. That how you will use it in neural network. Otherwise, it's not an independent study of NLP techniques, okay? So remember this inspiration that the idea is without hand designing too many things, can we have some general modules which can take care of the most of the parts? Okay, it doesn't mean, again, neural network is a general solver. No, it's not. Still, it's very much just a pattern recognition system. You will have to attach a lot of other modules to make it work in the real world. But for pattern recognition, how much automated we can make, that's the effort we have taken in neural networks. Okay, and in a very simple words, if you want to understand, feature selection or feature curating that you are doing, okay, that gets automated. It's very simple, in a very simple things, if you want to understand. Basically, the idea of it is he has not still bought it, man. What is happening here? Okay. Okay, I'm pinging him. Can you guys also start to ping him? Yes. Okay. All right. Some of this stuff, some of the slides material have also been used in my one another meetup. So if someone has attended, you might find some commonality. Okay. Okay. So, okay. Let's start with the slides itself. Look, at the end, this is the goal. At the end, this for all the industries, most of the industries, this is the whole part. There are a lot of redundant tasks. If I have to put humans in each task, it becomes time consuming, error prone, because humans will do some errors one way or other. And the problem is it is costly. You have to pay these people, right, at the end of the day. And any repetitive task, and you can think of n number of tasks. So one of the main tasks these days, which people are trying to do is, trying to come up with a set of frameworks or set of tools which automate the data cleaning and the data pipelining stuff. That's a major work. I think Kritish, you have something similar, right? Yeah, he is building something similar. And that's like a lot of AI companies have just jumped into it. And very seldom times you will find that, okay, you will get hired as data scientist or some name. Very seldom you will find that actually anything machine learning related. It's mostly system design, software engineering. It's classical. But why they have done it, again, the inspiration is same. Every time I have to clean the data. Every time. Every time, maybe with each data, I will have to have a new perspective. This NLP data is curated like this, text data is like this, image data is like this, sound data is connected like this. Every time I have to build a new channel or pipeline, and that takes time. So we come up with ETL tools, we come up with data cleaning tools, SAS tools, which are practically integrated suites to take over, okay? And if not possible, people design their custom platforms altogether on cloud or on premises, whatever is required, okay? And like Google Auto ML, how many people have heard about Auto ML? What is Google Auto ML? Okay, I will tell you. Auto ML is just basically their cloud. I thought Google has provided Auto ML.
And they provide the data. I don't know what it is, but you provide the data.
Azure has come with the same thing. Auto ML is the brand name, so you cannot just pitch it with any company. Yeah, everyone has. That's my whole point. IBM Watson has tried to do the same. AWS tried to do. Microsoft Azure has done. Yeah, ML Studio, you're right. So every major cloud player and lot of startups in Bangalore are doing exactly the same. They will call them AI startup and you ask them what AI work they do. Nothing. It's nothing related to AI. They are just building either UI or an end-to-end platform. Mostly that's the work. I'm not joking about this. Someone actually asked me yesterday in stats class that what is the scope of AI, and I bluntly said that actually with real AI work, I find it very less in India.
It has not been decided in the industry.
Yeah.
Interview also, they're asking like anything from here.
SQL, Python, programming, system design.
They are asking, I stopped giving it. They'll ask, like, if you go for an ML interview, they're asking, what is statistics? Facts is fine. Not things related to machine learning. If something asked them, they might be from statistics background completely.
No, many times I have. So, initially, when I came to Bangalore, so I didn't have like a clear path. I wanted to do my own startup. My dad told me, he doesn't know like how much work goes and everything. So he just told me like, try for a few jobs. So just for fun's sake, I used to go for interviews. I started like bashing few interviews 1 or 2 days. Like they pissed me out. Like I was like, this doesn't feel like an ML interview. I literally asked them, like, what is your background, man? Like you asked me everything. What is your background? What have you done in ML? And then I found it. He's just a software engineer for 4 years. He had just read some ML library and he's like bashing me.
Internally, they are switching because
That's what has been. So I literally told him, man. So basically, that logistic. Even in my class, I always tell, theoretically, logistic regression gives probabilities. And he was saying, no, it is class. I have seen it. I was like, kya isko bolu? Like this, has he read even a proper book in this text? I literally bashed him. Look, I will tell you the book name right now. I will tell you. Open this chapter, open this page, go for it, and you will find the derivation. And tell me the final answer, please. Is it a class or is it a probability? He is bashing me that logistic gives, like I use SQLearn. I was like, oh my God. But just because you are an interviewer, I literally told him, I don't care what you work you do, because it literally is sensing that real, actually AI or ML work doesn't happen here. You guys are mostly interested in software engineering. If I wanted to do that, I would have done it, okay? But I'm not here for you. Explicitly mentioned AI researcher and engineer. That was the job posting. And this, and the question they asked me, I was like shocked that day. I was like, what is happening? I was like, this is a data structure interview. What is happening? Literally, I was very confused. Yeah, everything. Apart from ML.
I think everyone's talking the same.
Yeah. Apart from ML, they leave out ML and then they ask everything.
They ask from their own background.
Yeah. So now the problem is, yeah. So one sec. So my point is, or the guys, थोड़ा मेरा भी discussion हो जाए. Okay, the point is, and this is the task. क्यों नहीं हो रहा है ना? क्योंकि यही चीज उन्होंने, this is what they realized. कि ठीक है, ML is, I have also taught in my classes, ML ना या DL 10-20% ही होता है पूरे काम का. 70-80% या 90% काम still normal software engineering ही है. उसे they want to automate that much, as much as possible. As much. Look, once you put the data in DL, क्या ही करते हो आप life में? What do you really do? चलता रहता है. हम उसके साथ खाने पीने चले जाओ, जिम चले जाओ, जो करना करो लाइफ में. इट कैन टेक 3 to 6 आवर्स और वीक्स डिपेंडिंग ऑन द डेटा सेट एंड हाउ बिग योर मॉडल इज टू ट्रेन. यू कैन डू लॉट ऑफ अदर थिंग्स इन लाइफ दैट इज हाईली ऑटोमेटेड. वंस इट गोज इनसाइड देन इज हाईली ऑटोमेटेड. यू डोंट एक्चुअली डू मच. ओके, बट रेस्ट ऑफ द सॉफ्टवेयर इंजीनियरिंग, एवरीथिंग डॉकर एंड एवरीथिंग व्हिच यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट, उसकी हालात दे आर इन द सेम कंडीशन. देयर इज नो एडवांसमेंट देयर टेक्निकली. Now there lies the problem. So this is why they want to automate things. Okay, once I get the data from different streams, it could be SAS flat files or some REST API sensor data, it should just come and then magically reach till the DL and the magically inference will come. Of course, we understand it's not that simple, but that's what the intuition is. And they will take this container in a Docker. Let's say ki isko pura Docker mein dal diya aur isko jaake on-premise har jagah deploy kar diya. ये इवन इन बैंगलोर मिनिमम आई नो 25 कंपनीज आर डूइंग एग्जैक्टली दिस. बस दैट्स द बिकॉज द मेजर कंसर्न इज देयर एट द एंड ऑफ द डे दैट यू विल बी एबल टू डिप्लॉय इट और नॉट. बट अब वही हो जाता है ना कि जो लोग प्यूरिटन व्यू है, जैसे मेरा थोड़ा प्यूरिटन व्यू है, तो आई एम लाइक नहीं यार, दैट इज नॉट मशीन लर्निंग. उसके लिए आप डेवॉप्स रख सकते हो ना यार. यू कैन हायर अ डेवॉप्स इंजीनियर हु कैन टेक केयर ऑफ दिस. इसके लिए आप एमएल या डीएल वाले इंजीनियर को क्यों स्ट्रेस दे रहे हो? यू जस्ट टेल व्हाट एग्जीक्यूटेबल यू वांट, आई विल क्रिएट यू. तुम करो उसे अपलोड, व्हाई इज इट माय इशू? सो मेरा अपना इसलिए हो जाता है कि नहीं, मैं उस पर ज्यादा वरी नहीं करता. एंड व्हेन माय प्रोजेक्ट्स हैव कम, आई हैव जस्ट लर्न थिंग्स ऑन द फ्लाई एंड डिप्लॉयड इट. बट देन यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस इज द होल ट्रबल एंड दिस इज द इंस्पिरेशन फॉर डीप लर्निंग और ऑटोमेटेड मशीन लर्निंग. There are so many redundant tasks which are costing companies billions, maybe globally if we look at it, is costing billions right now. So I was reading about this extra Canada pipeline they are trying to make. So in Alberta they have sand tars. So petrol is also found in sand. Okay, so there is a, so they are trying to extract those petrol extracts, and they are trying to send it towards the coast. Now Alberta is practically in the middle of the country. So, आप एक ये भी कर सकते हो कि आप ट्रक के थ्रू भेज सकते हो, बट दैट वुड बी वेरी कॉस्टली. नाउ व्हाट यू डू इज यू बिल्ड अ पाइपलाइन, मतलब पाइप डाल दिया और प्रेशर से उस पेट्रोल को फ्लो कराया आपने. नाउ इफ यू थिंक वेरी केयरफुली, इफ एवरीथिंग इज करेक्ट, दैट्स अ ऑटोमेटेड प्रोसेस. वंस यू पुश द पेट्रोल फ्रॉम दिस साइड, इट जस्ट रीचेस दैट अदर साइड, यू डोंट डू एनीथिंग. जैसे पानी जाता है, एक हो गया कि गाड़ियों से वो बॉटल में पानी आपके घर आ रहा है. देयर आर मल्टीपल स्टेप्स व्हिच आर हाईली रिपीटेटिव. एक हुआ कि पाइपलाइन बना दी है सरकार ने, तो लेक से उस पानी को दे रिलीज एंड वो अपने आप घर पे पहुंच जाता है. ये आपके छत पे टंकी होती है, उसमें पानी होता है एंड पानी अपने आप नीचे आता है. अगर आपको उस बाल्टी में जा जाके हर बार पानी लेके आना होता है, एंड दिस इज व्हाट कंपनीज फेस लॉट ऑफ टाइम. देर आर सो मेनी डिफरेंट सोर्सेस ऑफ डेटा. मेनी टाइम्स इट इज लिटरली कि लाइक हर के लिए एक सेपरेट बाल्टी है. आई गो देयर, आई पिक इट अप एंड देन आई डिप्लॉय मशीन लर्निंग ओवर देयर. दैट इज द पार्ट दैट इज वेरी फ्रस्ट्रेटिंग फॉर देम, एंड दैट इज वेयर लॉट ऑफ जॉब्स हैव बीन क्रिएटेड इन इंडिया एज ऑफ नाउ. Now, basically, this is what neural network is. So, this is what fundamentally neural network is, and this is how the whole idea is. Okay, that based on certain stimulus, whatever, so is it a dog or a cat? If you use neural network, it's a trained model, let's say it is a trained model. The idea is it should be able to classify. Right now, it is doing a classification. It should be able to tell it is a dog. Okay. Okay, and this is the whole idea, guys, at the end of the day. You started now. Let's say we can also go to the start of civilization. Let's not do that. Let's start with computer programming, that you were hard coding things. Okay. Yeah, or Joby, whatever requirements came, exclusively uske liye apne program likha, right? That's how 10-20 years ago this whole IT boom started in India. We were cheap engineers available throughout the world, एंड वी कुड राइट डेडिकेटेड प्रोग्राम्स फॉर योर नीड्स. 20 इयर्स अगर लोगों ने पैसे बनाए तो ऐसे बनाए. 20 इयर्स वे वो 2000 जब व्हेन माय अंकल्स एंड दीस गाइस वेंट टू यूएसए, दिस इज हाउ दे वेंट. दे रोट स्पेसिफिक कोड इन जावा, सी प्लस प्लस, वॉट एवर वॉज रिक्वायर्ड, जो वॉट एवर. सो वॉट एवर इट वॉज, दैट वॉज योर ब्रेड एंड बटर. After 2007 or 2010, or in USA at least, people have started to realize why writing scripting languages, we can automate lot of stuff. Lot of stuff, har bar someone doesn't have to press a button, things can automatically happen. And from there onwards, lot of jobs have been created in automation suits. Okay, you might have even worked with few automation suits, where when an email comes, few processes can just happen just by understanding the content of email, right? Now machine learning became, although machine learning was there for 50-60 years, so it's not nothing new right now, but last 10 years with the increasing compute power and the data, now what you can do is, let's say first you have to define a variable. Let's say ki if the variable acha maan lo temperature range hai, so if you know temperature range is between 40 to 45, take this action. Theek hai, earlier you had to hard code all of this. What if we can figure out which is the correct temperature range dynamically, regress kar lete hain us pe, and uske baad counter action lete hain aur classify kar lete hain. If it is a dog, open this gate. If it is a cat, open this gate. Theek hai,
so same process was there, but that was manual, like statistically.
Yeah, statistical. So classical machine learning was that, agreed. Mostly classical machine learning is statistical pattern recognition, no doubt about that. Now deep learning came, some of the parts became automated. Feature engineering is less. You can just throw the data as it is, it can take care of it internally. Okay, and it can give idea. Now pura idea ye ho gaya ki theek hai, we figured out DL, let's say DL ML pura suit hai aapke paas. Now the idea is with auto ML. The idea is, let's merge all these technologies. So let's merge traditional computer programming with automation, with machine learning, deep learning, and make a massive pipeline which could be as automatic as possible. So the idea is, if you put data over there, it will tell you, it will give you basic options. Okay, this is the data, this is the classification task, let me separate the data for you, let me use this function. It will give you some good options, so you do not have to wreck your brain over there ki yaar isme ye hota hai, ye hota hai. It will give you the best options anyways, and thus it is creating a pipeline. Now remember, this is a generic solution. There is always going to be difference between a generic solution and a specific solution. Generic solutions can again take a big market, but whenever you require something specific, that still has to be created. So as an, it will not be like ki there would be no requirements for data science once auto ML becomes it. No, it, there would be no market for casual data scientists. That's my answer here. Look, people tried this same approach with Android, iOS and BlackBerry and BardaOS. 4-5 years ago, people were trying to build suits, which you code in JavaScript and it will generate apps in all four OS. None of the suits took off. There is that problem. But the idea with deep learning is, and this is what Kritish said is very important, it can learn. Till that time, your conventional computer programming is not powerful enough to learn all four, right? So aap JavaScript ke through aap ek basic UI bana paoge. Maximum, that's all you can do. But any specific app cannot be designed like that. But with deep learning, you can start to learn. That's the advantage. Okay, and this is the whole point, that at some point it will be able to learn or kind of change its network depending on the data as real time data comes in, and hopefully we will not have to interfere too much. That's where the world is currently moving. Okay, so this is the cycle you have to understand right now. This is where robotic process automation. No. Here they are using ML and DL techniques to, let's say, select the best upper parameter. Let's say, okay, like you sometime might think, what is the good learning rate for linear regression? Now by observing the data and running some statistical process in backend, which you will not see, it has been abstracted from you. It will just tell you, know what, alpha 0.3 to 0.4 is a very good value. Choose anything. Okay, it will tell you, okay, out of these, what 5 good algorithms or what 5 kinds of neural networks, or okay, theek hai, you know there is a neural network gonna be used. How many layers we can approximate for you? ये भी तो एक बड़ा डिस्कशन है ना, व्हाट लेयर्स एंड हाउ मेनी लेयर्स, हाउ मेनी नोड्स. नो, नॉट नॉट वी आर नॉट हैविंग दैट डिस्कशन. इट इज गोना रन दैट इन बैक एंड एंड इट विल टेल यू दिस इज द बेस्ट अप्रोक्सीमेट. अगेन इट्स डूइंग अ ग्रिड सर्च. एज अ मशीन लर्निंग इंजीनियर यू शुड इमीडिएटली अंडरस्टैंड इट्स जस्ट डूइंग अ ग्रिड सर्च ऑन गूगल सर्वर्स विच आर इनक्रेडिबली पावरफुल. आपका डेटा ना बहुत छोटा होगा आइडियली, व्हाट गूगल हैज यूज्ड इट. गूगल डील्स विद पेटाबाइट्स एक्साबाइट्स राइट. सो आपके जीबी डेटा सेट एक्चुअली कुछ है नहीं उसके लिए. So it runs the massive grid search really fast and it just gives you some value. But it's a good thing, right? For a person who doesn't know, so person who is not a data scientist, so uske liye to bas ye ho gaya na, is setting hai na. If you can tell him the best setting, they understand. Why is there a problem then? Right? This is where AutoML has made life easy. Or hopefully, I'm not saying everyone is still using it. I will never use it. I'm like, what is the waste of time? But for a lot of casual people, I think this would be a good thing. And this is where a lot of startups in Bangalore are currently working. And maybe prepare few answers down this line. ठीक है ना, कुछ पूछे ना तो you have to guess this. कि actually they are asking something else. They are not asking machine learning. They are asking कि dude, we have lot of hard work while collecting the data, processing it, and more or less same ही होता है बार बार. इसके लिए तुम code लिख सकते हो कि नहीं? That's what they are really asking to you. Okay, once you understand this, you will at least have the upper hand over there. Okay, what they are asking and what you are expecting.
How to deal with
it? No, it depends. Na. You want to do that.
Point, but we are blank on this point. Okay.
Yeah.
So either you want to bluff completely.
Yeah, one thing you can bluff, like I can write this code.
Lag gaya to lag gaya.
Or you have to explain them that some processes can only be automated by use of extensive ML or DL. ठीक है, आप अपना काम भी निकाल सकते हो. You can also figure out कि look what optimization you want to do is possible through ML or DL techniques anyways. So let me collect this data on this whole pipeline, what goes wrong and everything, and let me do the same thing through ML and DL. So you are also creating the automation pipeline, but to optimize it, you are also using ML and DL. So both ho rahe hai. Now again, it depend karta hai team size kya hai, uske managers kaise hain. Best, the main thing is the managers who will be around you. If they are open-minded, lot of things are possible in life.
Party tools are also available, like
EFLO and all. Yeah, they are already available. So if the managers are okay with it, lot of things are possible. Agar manager ghatiya mil gaya to fir kuch kar nahi paoge aap. Ye baat bhi main abhi bol raha hu clear. Because yes, in corporate hierarchy there are lot of problems. Okay.
Funding
is one issue. Agar funding aa bhi gayi lekin manager is not open minded. Wo bol raha hai nahi, mujhe ek tool pata hai which works great, to sare log us pe jayenge. Kuch nahi kar paoge aap. Jo jitna cheekhna chillana hai. लेकिन इफ ए मैनेजर इज ओपन माइंडेड, वो कह रहा है कि नहीं 10% वी इन्वेस्ट इन फ्यूचर, वी लुक कि अच्छा ठीक है अभी दिस टेक इज वर्किंग, बट लेट्स इन्वेस्ट 10% ऑफ आवर टाइम एंड रिसोर्सेज इन लुकिंग इन फ्यूचर टेक. सो चलो कुछ और पीओसी ट्राई करते हैं. दैट्स हाउ लॉट ऑफ कंपनीज आर गेटिंग इनटू एमएल एंड एआई. दे आर ट्राइंग आउट डिफरेंट पीओसीज, व्हाटएवर इज पॉसिबल विद देम. कितने लोग नहीं ओपन है, दे आर लाइक नहीं आई नो ए टूल व्हिच वर्क्स गुड, लेट्स डू इट, फॉरगेट अबाउट एनीथिंग एल्स. सो दैट्स वेयर थिंग्स आर. ओके, although I don't think so, I need to teach this. I hope if someone is doubtful, they can ask me immediately and I'm more than happy to answer. But this is kind of this Venn diagram thing that I regularly get asked, what is AI, what is data science and everything. And I think this Venn diagram is the best explanation. So as you can see, machine learning is one bubble inside artificial intelligence. This bubble is so big because it has seen most amount of success in AI research so far compared to any other technique. But it doesn't mean some other technique can't come in future after 5 years and replace machine learning. 10 years ago, no one was betting on neural networks. Now everyone is like, how to find a neural network use case? Everyone, that's the major problem they have in life. Okay. So. Sorry. No, data science, what takes from deep learning should be the question. It's the reverse thing. Data science for predictions will either use some kind of ML, AI or deep learning technique. Okay, each one is basically a specialized idea. Okay, artificial intelligence over there, you have a domain of machine learning. Over machine learning, there is a domain of deep learning. Okay, so data science is making good use of machine learning and deep learning technologies. Okay,
I have one thing.
Sure.
The entire diagram is called our data engineering.
For me as
there
a.
There is no scripted. No confirm, but I mean, after attending so many interviews, I realized that is data engineering.
I don't.
I use big data as well.
Big data as well, yes.
No, this is not sort of data
No, but I am not saying that I am correct. But market trend is the entire diagram now is called data engineering. If you are applying for a data engineering job, you should know all those things, including.
मुझे तो किसी ने बताया नहीं कि AI develop हो गया, मैं बेकार ही research कर रहा हूँ इस field में बैठ के इतने दिन से. नहीं देखो, AI की debates में अगर आप जाओगे ना तो काफी अभी भी fight है. पहले तो हम ये, we are not even sure what true AI is, which technique should be even called AI. हर किसी नहीं, इट इज डेवलपिंग. सो दैट्स व्हाई जो चीज अननोन है उसको आप कैसे इतने कॉन्फिडेंस से बोल रहे हो कि
बट इंटरव्यू उसी पे ही तो हमें रिजुमेलेट करता है, ऐसा लगता है मोरे स्टोरे वाला पूछ रहे हैं. नहीं, आई फेल लाइक मोलेसिशन काइंड ऑफ थिंग. मेरे ईमेल का डेटा बिग डेटा पूछने लगा, व्हाट इज बिग डेटा ऑल दोस थिंग.
या दैट दैट हैव. सो लुक अगेन,
I keep question pucha, let me speak you honestly here, the company's quest.
So actually, at least they ask as far as
नहीं देखो, अब प्रॉब्लम ही हो जाते हैं, डेटा साइंस में काफी कुछ है ना. यहाँ पे काफी कुछ आया ना डेटा साइंस में, ये जो बाकी का ब्लॉक बचा हुआ है जो AI के बाहर है, सॉरी इसमें तो काफी कुछ है ना. फिर अभी इतनी जल्दी खत्म नहीं हो जाता ना, फिर यहाँ पे आपके प्रेजेंटेशन पे आ जाते हैं तो आपका टैबलो भी इसके अंदर, हाँ टैबलो और पावर बी आई जो भी है इसमें. अभी डेटा साइंस जो AI के सर्कल के बाहर गया ना उसमें बहुत कुछ है. अनफॉर्चुनेटली ज्यादा लोग ना इसमें ही चले जाते हैं, लाइक इधर से नहीं पूछना है मुझे, इधर उन्हें हाँ तो मैं इधर से पूछता
हूँ.
नहीं ठीक है, नहीं ठीक ही है. नहीं देखो, मैं कृतिश ने एक बार पूछा था ना, गेव हिम दिस एडवाइस कि देखो जो इनिशियल जो HR होते हैं ना जो फोन पे आते हैं, अगर इफ पॉसिबल या ईमेल के थ्रू इफ पॉसिबल ट्राई टू काइंड ऑफ नो कि हु इज गोना टेक योर इंटरव्यू, व्हाट काइंड ऑफ पीपल, इफ पॉसिबल लुक एट देयर लिंक्डइन प्रोफाइल. आइडिया लग जाता है कि क्या होने वाला है, थोड़ा सा ना रिसर्च खुद से भी करना पड़ेगा. हाँ कहीं के मैं मानता हूँ कि नहीं बताते. अच्छा वॉक इन भी स्टार्ट हो गया.
हेलो,
या
हेलो अमिताभ.
या
आई एम सागर. डिड आई मिस अ लॉट ऑफ कॉन्सेप्ट?
या टेल मी.
Hello. Did I miss a lot on the conceptual part? I just joined my right now.
Okay, fine.
Hello. Yeah, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
No, I'm saying मैंने कुछ बहुत ज़्यादा miss नहीं कर दिया.
No, we were just talking about because okay, so some people are here new, so we are talking about some parts of AI and deep learning. And then we will start switch with NLP as well. Okay.
Okay. Actually, I did not like attend many of the sessions, like three sessions of this deep learning. Sorry, computer vision. So did you finish computer vision?
Yeah, that's done. We have even finished one project over there.
So did we use Watson and all? IBM Watson?
You can ask Krishna when IBM Watson is going to start.
Okay. But computer vision is done, right? So you also taught over there how we can use the automated models, right?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, guys, we can have that discussion later. Silence. Okay. So you guys might have seen so there is a lot of idea, and basically one of the ideas basically I have worked in, so I have not exactly worked on self-driving, but I was working on merging computer vision with the car safety. Okay, basically this is what I was working on. Although once you start going in depths of these, and this is the whole idea again, why we are using deep learning and ML. So like now we have CV, okay? So let's say you put cameras up front, inside and whatnot, okay? So my work was very limited to cameras inside, monitoring the passengers and their act. Okay. So let's say we are regularly recording their videos, okay? Now we have now you can merge other sensors, or maybe computer vision is more than enough. For sometimes at night, you might need to have some infrared sensors inside and outside as well. Okay. Now for a car, sometimes it is first you have to localize yourself. Where are you driving? Okay. And then you might also have to path plan, like how will you reach if there are multiple paths, and basically accordingly how to control the controls, or how to basically get the controls so that your car is moving in the correct direction. Okay. So if this is the path, it should be able to follow it. But somewhere, what if this dot is not available? It should be able to understand how big and wide the road is. It should be able to avoid the obstacles and try to find its own path. Now you can understand, you cannot handcraft this. It's very hard. Handcraft this kind of system or learning is very hard. Scenarios on road changes so fast. Even if you try to handcraft it, it's not going to work. People have tried this even before DARPA challenge of 2007, but it just doesn't work. If the learning mechanism is not automated, which should be able to adopt against the data very fast, it's not going to work. It's going to fail in any scenario which it might not have seen or predicted at all. It is going to fail very, very fast. That's going to happen. Okay. And that's the whole problem. This is where the requirement are, because you might deal with complex problems where one design system design is not going to work. So if your model or the system is adapting, then there is any chance of some commercial success. So in USA, you might know, like Teslas are already running. So they are not fully autonomous, but on like highways and these things, you can like literally leave them free and they will keep on driving. Okay. And when there is too much traffic, they prompt you to take the wheel immediately. But semi-autonomy is almost available now with Teslas. Okay. Google Waymo, basically the car, they have constructed an artificial city in Arizona, and they have been keep running in cars over there 24/7, means any weather. Although Arizona is still very dry, the test will be in Boston, where they have 5 feet of snow. So there would be a different kind of scenario. But Arizona is like very sunny and dry most of the year. So you always have sufficient light, not too much rains and everything. So they are doing it in California. They have run it through. They have run it on almost all the national or the freeways of USA already. So now it is showing that with deep learning, you can actually possibly solve this problem. It basically, as it sees the data, it starts to adapt. Okay. That's the whole idea. And this is why deep learning solutions are becoming de facto in any kind of real world scenario. Only problem, two problems are there. It is data intensive and it is compute expensive. In dono pe na ab shortcut nahi le paoge. If you take shortcut, the accuracy is gonna be worse than maybe an SVM. Matlab SVM use kar lete jyada easy hota life mein. If you want to use deep learning properly, you will require a lot of data and a lot of compute power. And sometimes even locally, not on a server, sometimes just to get an inference locally it is required. Okay, locally means on the exact device where it is gonna make that prediction. Okay, because what if the car loses internet connection then? You cannot do all the processing on your server and then keep sending results. All these processing needs to happen. Now car has a lot of space. So maybe I can take out some space and put up GPUs and computers over, which can be done, which has been done. Maybe for some other vehicles, it might not be possible. Maybe for a bike, it would be very hard. Okay. Maybe for a mobile device is still very, so you take out internet connection and Google search result does not work. Or even if you want to do like, okay, who is in this picture? It cannot do it locally. It cannot translate your languages. It requires an active internet connection. Now the whole push is how we can do it locally. So they will put a word embedding system in this at some point. It will be a 200, 300 MB. And then the apps will be able to do that regularly offline. And they will upload the data when it connects again. But it will be able to do predictions offline after a while. That's Google's and even cause Google is doing, Apple has to do it in their iOS, otherwise how is going to survive? So yes, they are working very hard. All of the major companies are working, but remember, they have maybe trillions or exabytes, petabytes of data to even train upon. Okay, so that's much their control. They have that much their control with them.
The power is also a concern.
Sorry?
Power
as
if
in?
We make it into local.
So this slide actually has a lot of links. Sorry, okay, why is doing this? And basically, we are trying to show you that every big country, US, Canada, several countries of Europe, China, are really doing some really good work. And so this is the idea of GPT. So now NLP inspiration will come. GPT. GPT is a open, okay, so there is a company called OpenAI, which was initially funded by Elon Musk, and there are a lot many investors on the board. So they have come up with a very big model. It's called GPT-2 right now. And it is so good. Okay, I will show you the GPT-2 model right now. Okay, so if you go to here, gpt2language.openai.com, it can even show you. Okay, so read what it is saying right now. Can you tell it is like machine generated? Like, and every time you hit enter, it kind of comes up with a new story or like something more explanation. So this is just one example, but rather we kind of check out the whole thing anyways, because GPT-2 is something very fantastic. Now, GPT-2 model has not been released publicly because of the fears it might get misused. The idea is it is so realistic. You will not be able to tell you are talking to a bot on the other side. Okay, so the code is available. The problem is it is such a massive thing. They had to train this for 6 to 7 months on their server farms. So for a normal person, it would be practically impossible to train this thing. Even if you have the complete code is available. If you want, go for it, but you will not be able to train it. That I'm also telling you right now. It is that massive right now. The papers are there and they have even told you how many. So for the large one, which is the most accurate one, it contains 774 million parameters. Means that many weights. People who have done machine deep learning, they are already understanding what is the complexity we are talking about. And there is also a data set and there is already blog post and everything. So you can kind of go ahead and play and even check out the correct, the good examples that they have at least bothered to show. Okay, fine. Read this. So this is given by us. We start a kind of a story or like we give two lines. And then in 10 tries, what it produces. They are practically scoured the internet. That's how you think out. Google and these guys are practically covering the whole internet. Whatever English text they could find, they have trained on. Read the story. It literally looks like something has been actually found. Machine can practically convince you. Okay, switch unicorns here. Okay, now unicorns, you know, are magical. Okay, magical animals. Just switch this part, unicorns. Just put it something else. It can generate such a realistic story and you can publish it in a blog and people will actually find it is correct. There's not even a single grammatical mistake. I have like seen it again and again. I'm like, how good is this thing? So if I generate a chatbot based on this, you will not realize you are not talking to actually human. It is that good right now. So similarly, there is a BERT model. If you want to check, there are some really good models which have just become available and it's like a good time to like, so this is by Google. Again, this is again a good model. The good thing is you can find a pre-trained model. So we can maybe by the end of the NLP, we may be able to do something with BERT, not with GPT. Okay. BERT is available and again you put something and then whole thing it starts to print out. Okay, so we will see how to kind of work with all of these, but just to see the accuracy and how good it can, it has literally made a story. Like you can publish this in a newspaper and you're like, wow, people will actually believe it. It is that good. And this is why they have not released the model. Otherwise, once I have the model, trained model with me, then I can practically generate false stories every day. Means these days humans are generating so many stories. So humans have a certain pace of generating a meme or something, right? Machine will just outdo us. Machine will just curate a fake story based on each person. Right now, okay, they are targeting communities, right? So they figure out which cluster you belong to and those kind of WhatsApp messages, Facebook messages are shown to you, right? Now with this, I can target person to person. I can curate it so very well that it will hit you personally somewhere. It will feel like, okay, no, this is an insult to my country in a way that you might feel most insulted. And then I can spread hate, anger, anything that I want to. a lot of times, how you detect it is a meme or something. Many times it's just poor English. You can simply tell who writes like this. Many times, no problem, sir, ma'am. You just look at the English. You'll be amazed, like, how would you even detect this is wrong? You will actually think some news editor has literally sat on his computer and written it properly. They have done their research, how the whole research was done. Right? How would you counter this? So this has become the major concern with a lot of AI technologies that in their narrow domain, they have become. Now, again, this cannot start detecting images. That is not going to happen. It is going to do such crap work. This is where humans just have the advantage, just so far. But with this narrow domain, and plus, okay, now we can have convolutional neural networks, which are detecting images better than humans. In their own specific domains, they have become really, really good right now. Similarly with speech translation and whatnot. In the narrow world, they have really become very good. And you have to be very careful while interacting with these things. And this is why, please, even in our deep learning, I told you, please do not take care of your data. Otherwise, once I get hold of these kind of models and I have your personal data, I can just retrain this model based on your personal data and I can target you very easily. It would be a piece of cake for us. And hackers can really target if they wanted to. So please really take care of your data. Do not see a free app or some app which is giving you some goodies and just upload your data. Especially like credit card numbers or chat history or photos. You have to be very careful these days. 10 years ago, it was not a problem. But these days, it has really become a problem. If someone has hundreds of photos of yours, we can generate a realistic video of you. Maybe you are giving a hate speech somewhere in Saudi Arabia. Like, when did I go there? But it can very easily happen. Because of GANs and transformer networks, it is so easy these days. I rather require just 5 minutes of your video, which we can, I think, find on your Facebook. So if it is not, if you have just kept it public, I can just go on your Facebook and I can just maybe see it. That's all it will take. So hide it properly. Even if you are uploading it, do not make it available to the whole world. It is very problematic. Because more data we have or we can collect on you, more personalized attacks we can make against you. Or more personalized, look how it starts. It mostly starts with personalized advertising. Yeah, that's how it always starts. There is a very good movie. I want you to see it as a homework. It's more or less a documentary. Please watch it. Okay. If you have watched it, you have already done yourself a favor in life. But if not, please watch it. The Great Hack will really terrify you from inside. You were like, holy shit. It is talking about the things which has already happened in this. It's not, we are not even talking about something fictional. These things already happened. It is literally showing election results were affected. Yeah, US, they have told about 19 elections throughout the world. It's not even US. They are inflicting so many elections. So it is similar. It is the same idea that, okay, once I figure out which cluster you belong to, we target ads like that. We target video campaigns and everything. We control the content and we flood the internet with the content. Wherever you see Instagram, Facebook, WhatsApp, or any messaging system. And then that's all you see because Facebook personalizes everything, right? So that's the aim and you do not feel any weird. You are like, yeah, this is the truth. And then anyone comes, no, they are wrong. And then they will start fighting you. Like they told like, oh, you do not know some basic questions because that's their world. That's all they do fundamentally. So they are more than willing to target a person who actually knows machine learning. Same thing happens on a personal level, political level. And AI now, it depends how your value systems are. It could be a great tool. It could be, we could invent medicines which can cure really large number of people very cheaply. Even if we find a new strain of influenza or something, we will be able to make a medicine within maybe 12 hours. Because AI will be able to find this pattern really fast and then it will be able to find protein bindings where we can attack. Okay, most of the times that takes care of it. But then it can also create that virus which no one will be able to stop. So you have to be very careful what you are developing with AI because these models are really getting very powerful now. And a lot of them, like Google BERT models, are openly available for free. So if you really set your mind to it, it's not very hard. Okay. And here you can go, and they have explained how whole thing works, and they have used different kind of data sets, and you can see some accuracies are really very scary if you really look at. For any children level, I can literally convince the child. Maybe adult level, I still can figure out something is wrong. If they are saying children book test common nouns 93.3 and children book test name entities, it is 89.05. That's not a joke. It means to the age, child of age 8 or 10, we can practically convince them they are talking to an actual adult. And they will not even know it because their vocabulary is limited, right? It is running at 93.3%. Even humans, just humans can get 96. Previous record were at 85. This is the only very slim chance, and within a year you will see they would have breached this 96. So how a child is going to suspect if this is the accuracy level they are up against? Maybe as an adult you still can figure out by counter questioning. Child has no chance here. So this is like a personal. So my sister, I went to her to for Rakhi, and she was telling how her elder son is like not understanding the part of technology. So he has the access to phone, to my brother-in-law's phone basically, and my sister's phone as well. And he buys games. Now you have linked your credit card, right? So you go to Google Play, and if you know the PIN, he just buys the game. Now, this is very trivial, but then you can also start buying things which are not necessary, but you can get basically convinced by these things. And many times these things are so personalized after a while, it is tricky. YouTube, okay, so recently it has happened and you should know. YouTube basically lost a massive suit and they will have to pay massive fines because they collected data on children. YouTube has launched a new app which are child friendly, and if you have kids at home, please make sure they always log into that, always. Because if by mistake they collect data on that, you can believe YouTube will be finished in this world. Because of GDPR and these laws, these guys are really monitoring them. Unfortunately, in India, that privacy laws are not very high. But still, because these companies are in US and Europe, we can still like make a case of it. So if you have kids, especially under age of 10, even if you're in your own family, make sure even if they consume some content, they consume on YouTube Kids. Not on the general YouTube, because the general YouTube doesn't, it will collect data irrespective of your age. So if you have YouTube Kids, that's what they have promised. We will not collect data on that. So this is the scenario in this world right now, that YouTube, which you might not think what bad YouTube can do, they are collecting data on your kids right now. And they can personalize targeted ads. That's how it will start, targeted ads, and then the agenda will change someday. After a while, it will be selling. First, it will be selling them pictures, stickers, and whatnot. Then it will be about clothes, shoes. Then it will be like what kind of school or where you want to go vacation or what fancy restaurant you should eat. And at certain age, it would be also becoming political. And all of this data will be available not only to the people who want to do good, also to the people who want to do bad in this world. Because they will sell the data. That's as simple as that. So be just careful. That's my whole point. Because once I look at these accuracies, especially wherever you are seeing the accuracy, and when I start to see these kind of, so somewhere it is okay that there is too much difference. But wherever I see something reaching 90%, I'm already afraid. Because what it means is on a general day, you will not be able to detect the difference. So this is the power which we are very much against these days. Okay. One sec. And we are kind of revising, so if you know something, don't worry. Sorry. Hold on. I hope everyone already knows by this time. Basically, deep learning is nothing, is just a specialization of machine learning. Okay. Now, machine learning is divided in practically three domains: supervised, unsupervised, and reinforcement learning. What is a supervised example? You literally tell them it is a cat, it is a dog, and you train your model. Over the time, model will learn, or it will hypertune the hypothesis. And at the end of the day, output would be given where it will tell, is it a cat or is it a dog? Simple. That's a supervised. Now you can have a k-means where you might try to detect these kind of centers where it is just the data. We have no sense, but it just tries to make, like, let's say clusters, as many clusters as you have told, with certain iterations, and it just tries to plot these kind of diagrams for you, and it just shows you this much can be done even unsupervised. Maybe you guys might have seen this kind of example. So it's a DeepMind model, basically. They released this in 2016 or 17. Over there, they showed that why using reinforcement learning, they can teach a virtual model to basically run, walk, and climb. It fails a lot of time, no doubt. It fails so many times. These are like good videos, okay? And it kind of, yeah, it fails a lot of times. But it shows the power of learning. Even if it falls, so the smaller ones are not the problem. Whenever in the tall ones it fails, it keeps on jumping, keeps on jumping, keeps on increasing its angle, and at some point it crosses it over. And it keeps learning. And this is the whole point of automated learning. So that I do not have to handcraft. Now, I can change different kind of obstacles. The idea is, after a while, it will figure out that obstacle as well. Similarly, very much the way humans do. So this is the power we are really dealing with these days. Okay. Just a basic idea. Because in our deep learning, it's not open for all. First of all, you guys need to know. You need to know Python, statistics, and machine learning. Okay. Unless basics are not done, you cannot actually get into deep learning properly and you will not be able to do well. So,
hello.
Yeah.
I'm just talking about Sagar. I'm saying that reinforcement learning or auto ML mein farak kya hoga?
Okay. So, auto ML is a complete suite. Reinforcement learning is a kind of field of study within machine learning. Okay. So, reinforcement learning is based on reward and some kind of punishment. That whenever you get something wrong, you are given a negative score. When you get something right, you get a positive score. The idea is to maximize your score. Okay. Now, AutoML.
In reinforcement?
Sorry?
Reinforcement, right?
Yeah, this was the definition of reinforcement. AutoML is automating some task in the ML pipeline. When you collect the data, it automatically can impute the missing values. It can tell you which strategy to go with. You just need to select the strategy. So it will tell you like these three strategies make sense here. Which one you want me to, and you just click. Okay, you replace it with mean. It will automatically replace it with mean. Okay, it will figure out best hyperparameters based on the scores, grid search that it internally runs. And you can get a good sense like what kind of hyperparameters you want. Although Google is trying to do some kind of reinforcement learning as well. So I think in future, AutoML will also have parts of reinforcement learning. But right now, mostly they have achieved it through deep learning itself so far. Okay, but Google is always working in reinforcement learning. And there, I would not be surprised if AutoML also has some parts of reinforcement learning at the back end. You will not be able to see it, but it might be using it. Okay, is that clear?
Yeah, aajkal to pura class, I think, bahut basic class ja raha hai, I think.
Yeah, mostly I have told here. So most people, quite a lot of people are new here. So we need to cover the basics today first. And whatever time we will start with basic NLP. And from the coming classes, I think you missed the initial parts. Coming classes, so we will have full on NLP classes. Okay. So ideally, the idea is within 6 main full classes, we will be able to cover most of the NLP topics. Okay.
अच्छा मतलब आज का मतलब ऐसे ऊपर से जो क्या है पूरा हमारा कोर्स स्ट्रक्चर हुआ.
Making sure everything is clear to everyone.
Okay.
And I guess you guys understand all this anyways. So if you kind of studied everything, you will have to worry about. So this is what in AutoML you will have to worry. अगर कल किसी को आपके किसी को बोल दिया ना कि नहीं मुझे AutoML जैसा कुछ चाहिए, कुछ इसी तरह से करना पड़ेगा. This is what you will have to do. First, you will have to look how many samples you have. You will have to figure out what you want to do. You want to predict a category or you want to have a regression idea, okay? If regression, then go in which direction? Then if you have too much data, what you should do? How you should reduce your dimensionality reduction, okay? Then what kind of kernel approximation might be required, okay? Then either if a quantity, then go for regression. If it is labeled data, if yes, then go for classification. No, then clustering. If you see it very carefully, although it is scikit-learn algorithm cheat sheet, but technically, kisi ne isko hi cloud pe bana diya. If-else condition, lot of benchmarks. Okay, so kitni bar, lot of times when you go through different networks. Okay, as we see, kernel approximation, SGD classifier, K-neighbors, NIBIS. Many times it is a fine balance between accuracy, precision, and recall. You understand, kahin kahin pe accuracy still could be very high, but it doesn't mean you are actually doing great. So internally, you will have to do a lot of things. And again, you can put neural networks or some kind of learning mechanism to fine tune each algo. Okay. And this is the whole idea. So yeah, it should be there actually, but it's okay. So, but this is the whole idea, that this is how you start with. And these are auto ML ideas, basically, that this is how a lot of people have built their ML suits. That fundamentally, these are the behaviors you might have to classify them. So aap har jagah jaake tick karo, ya batao ki acha yahan pe 5 options, I will select this. You just keep selecting on an upper level, internally it will get the work done. Okay. Like if you had to, okay, if someone remembers from our data science, how many lines of the code was linear regression? Jo khud se likha hoga. Yeah, so I in my class, actually in linear regression, I give complete numpy code of linear regression. Can I 15 lines? ठीक है. SKLearn में करने पे कितने lines हो गए थे? 4 lines. वही abstraction ही यहाँ पे provide हुआ. You can also do everything on your own, right? ऐसा कुछ भी मतलब on an average अगर आप एक बार पढ़ लो तो सब कुछ खुद से भी कर सकते हैं इंसान. अब चूंकि let's say this same thing is done by 25 students, sir. Okay, or 25 workers. So rather I figure out, why don't I make a pipeline, I give a GUI interface and people just start clicking. So my training ka time bach jata, right? I don't have to train everyone in every algorithm. I just have to tell them upar se main bata dunga, dekho ye hota hai to ye hota hai ye hota hai.
Now even companies like EMI, what they are doing, they are not hiring experience.
ज्योति नहीं है ना, यही प्रॉब्लम है ना. इसके चलते क्या होता है, देखो दो चीजें हो जाती है. एक हो जाता है कि फिर अब लेट्स से अगर मैं जाता हूँ बोलता हूँ कि नहीं मेरे पास 10 इयर्स एक्सपीरियंस है पर मैं इतना चार्ज करूंगा, दे आर लाइक कि इससे बेटर एक सूट बना देते हैं, कॉलेज वाले स्टूडेंट्स को लेते हैं जो इससे 10 times चीपर निकलेंगे लास्ट में, और इनको 2 महीने की ट्रेनिंग देनी है, ऊपर से सिखाना है, इन्हें मशीन लर्निंग एक्सपर्ट तो बनना नहीं है लाइफ में. देन अगेन यू बिकम द रिसोर्स जो अब तक चलता रहा सर्विस इंडस्ट्री में, क्योंकि इन्हें देखो इन्हें कोई खास फर्क है नहीं रिसर्च और इंस्टीट्यूट से. दीस गाइस आर गूगल या एप्पल की तरह, इनकी सोच नहीं है कि इनको पूरा वर्ल्ड कॉन्क्वायर करना है, इनको सर्विस इंडस्ट्री में रहना है मोस्टली या कंसल्टिंग. सो दे स्टार्ट टू फिगर आउट व्हाट इज द चीपेस्ट वे टू डू द सेम थिंग, और हाउ कैन. सो जो 10 साल वाला एक्सपीरियंस वाला बंदा आएगा वो आपसे दबने वाला भी नहीं है ऑन एन एवरेज डे, लेकिन कॉलेज वाले को तो आप जरा धमका के रख सकते हो. उसे बोल सकते हो 3 साल के पहले गए तो तुम्हें तो स्टॉक्स में दे नहीं रहे कुछ, रो बैठ के. जिसके पास 10 इयर्स का एक्सपीरियंस है वो थोड़ा डरने वाला तुमसे, बोलेगा ठीक है मैं दूसरी कंपनी में जा रहा हूँ. कॉलेज वाले
अच्छा, अमृतांश
या
लाइक मैं गूगल गया था अपना इंटरव्यू देने के लिए, मैं लास्ट राउंड अगले हफ्ते तक पता लग जाएगा क्या है रिजल्ट या नहीं है. इट वाज टू टफ बट आई डिड दैट, आई गॉट द आउटपुट्स.
चलो अच्छा है, आई होप यू गेट द जॉब ओवर देयर.
मतलब मुझे तो वो है कि डेवलपमेंट की पोजीशन ही मिलेगी, बिकॉज स्टडी उस पर है ना, मैं कितनी बार अप्लाई करता हूँ डेटा साइंस वगैरह में, कहते हैं वी कांट गिव यू दिस पोजीशन, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल बहुत एक्सपीरियंस चाहिए, नंबर टू यू आर वेरी यंग फॉर गेटिंग इनटू दिस जॉब. सॉरी मैन
एंड यू विल हैव टू एक्वायर द कोई नहीं, यू फाइंड अ डेवलपमेंट जॉब ओवर देयर एंड गूगल इज वर्किंग ऑन लॉट ऑफ एमएल प्रोजेक्ट्स, इवन ऑन एंड्रॉइड पे भी उनके एमएल प्रोजेक्ट स्टार्ट हो चुके हैं. ठीक है,
मैंने उनसे बोला था, मतलब आप मैंने उनसे बोला कहते हैं लास्ट में कि आर देयर एनी क्वेश्चंस, तो मैंने वही पूछा कि लाइक व्हाट आर द चैलेंजेस ऑफ दिस जॉब पोजीशन एंड हाउ विल दिस जॉब हेल्प ओवरकम दैट, तो वो तो कुछ बता ही नहीं रहे. इट इज ये, इट इज वो, इट इज कॉन्फिडेंशियल
ब्यूरोक्रेसी, राइट? फेसबुक में जाते तो थोड़ा कम होता है नाटक, गूगल का ब्यूरोक्रेसी बहुत ज्यादा है, तो ऐसा उसकी भी गलती नहीं होगी, उसे पता नहीं होगा. Google has abstracted a lot of things over there. I know because some people I personally know are in Google as of now. They also say the same. Unke managers ko bhi puri baat nahi pata hoti. Google has become that kind of a massive hierarchy. Us hisab se Facebook is still very flat. Within 2-3 people you can figure out what is happening here. Google mein aisa 20 log ho sakte hain puri chain mein.
Matlab jab maine apna last round diya usse pehle ye matlab ye mera 8th round tha jo maine diya. तो 8वें राउंड के अंदर इन लोगों ने एक ऐसा मुझसे करवाया कि फोन पर इन लोगों ने एक ऐसा एडिटर खोला कि जब मैं कोड करा था तो इनका भी वो कोड दिख रहा था, प्लस ये मेरे कोड में जाके छिड़खाने भी, मतलब इतना ज्यादा, मतलब ये लोग बाइकी से मुझे चेक कर रहे थे कि ये है वो है ये है वो है मेरा, मतलब प्रॉपर वीडियो रिकॉर्ड करते टाइम मुझसे एक फॉर्म भरवाया गया कि तो वीडियो रिकॉर्ड होगा.
गूगल एंड ऑल दीस माइक्रोसॉफ्ट आर वेरी क्यूरियस. 6-7-8 राउंड्स इज जस्ट नॉर्मल मैन, किस लोग के 10 राउंड भी होते हैं. थोड़ा अगर सीनियर रोल में तुम जा रहे होते हैं ना तो मैं 10 राउंड हो रहे होते हैं वहां पे, तो इवन इंडिया में भी अमेज़न ने काफी बड़ा कैंपस खोला हैदराबाद में. सो पीपल हु हैव बीन हायर्ड फॉर SD2 और SD3 हैड टू गिव 9 टू 10 राउंड्स. ऐसे ही अमेज़न थोड़ा ना हायर कर रहा है, ऐसे थोड़ा ना 50 लाख दे देगा कि चलो. हाँ वो तो है. या सर इट इज नथिंग वेरी न्यू टू बी वेरी ऑनेस्ट. ओके okay, so I'm not going to go much in the neural network because iski class achche se hum log karenge. But the idea is at the end of the day, it is a pattern recognizer system. You have to understand this, okay? Over a period of time, weights are learned and basically it will start to make predictions as the learning happens correctly. So as you can see, the basically weights propagate or basically the information propagates, and this is showing the dropout as well. And at the end of the day, basically it will try to make the correct prediction for you. Okay, yeah, artificial neurons. Okay, so this is the whole idea at the end of the day. Okay, that you first take the information, then as you can see, it goes like column by column and everything, and hopefully you learn. Okay, so you keep showing the data by optimizing the number of layers, number of nodes per layer, and choice of your activation function, what kind of either a local max pooling you have applied, dropout, and there are so many other techniques that we use to kind of avoid overfitting and stuff. But this is fundamentally, that's all it is. Okay. Okay. And if someone wants to know this, this is the whole idea basically. Basically, from data gathering to data parsing to model creation to accuracy testing, this is usually a machine learning engineer's job. But usually, people define it much, much bigger. I will show you that figure as well. That if they really want to get cranky, what they can ask. But this is the whole idea. That fundamentally, first you have to define your problem. So first you define, and this is what I say. First you should know what you are dealing with. Even in interview questions, it is actually, you know, with projects, I think maybe Kirtish might have also experienced this. Many times they will really get you behind. First, कितनी बार तो बस वो समझना चाह रहे हैं कि दूसरी companies क्या कर रही हैं. So they want to understand. हाँ करते क्या और क्यों करते हो. या फर्स्ट क्लियर द ऑब्जेक्टिव एंड दिस इज द फर्स्ट थिंग. व्हाट आर वी ट्राइंग टू डू, हाउ डू वी डिफाइन सक्सेस. अगर आप में सिर्फ आप एक्यूरेसी बोल के नहीं भाग सकते आगे. हाँ बिजनेस में क्या एप्लीकेशन इंक्रीज हुआ. इफ वी डिड दिस मॉडल करेक्टली, इवन लेट्स से वी गॉट 85% एक्यूरेसी, हाउ मच बिजनेस दे गॉट मोर और उसके चलते प्रॉफिट लाइन क्या हुई. इस बात की अगर आपको समझ है ना, दे रियली अप्रिशिएट. उसके बाद डेटा गैदरिंग हो सकती है. नाउ इट कुड बी सेंसर डेटा. अगेन यहाँ पे काफी कुछ हो सकता है. रेस्टफुल एपीआई के थ्रू डेटा ट्रैवल कर रहा होगा, स्ट्रीमिंग डेटा हो सकता है, और स्टोर डेटा इन डेटाबेसेस और समथिंग. ओके, अब अगर यहाँ पे स्टोर डेटा वाली कंपनी मिल गई तो एसक्यूएल पूछेंगे वो लोग. देयर इज नो चांस कि एसक्यूएल जाने देंगे आपसे. अगर कोई रियल टाइम वाला मिल गया तो वो रेस्ट एपीआई के पीछे भागेंगे थोड़ा सा, या काफ्का वगैरह के पीछे जाएंगे कि कौन से टूल्स हैं विच कैन रियल टाइम स्ट्रीम द डेटा. Now again, there is too much variation. Without knowing the company's domain and how they work, it would be tricky to like make a conjecture, but this is a process. Now, once the data is there, although still between data gathering and there could be still data cleaning module, but chuki bas hum log machine learning perspective pe, then you separate your training data, testing data, and even validation data if you have to. Then you run multiple models. I've always told it's not about a single model which can overcome everything. It is about you test multiple models, you get your scores, and you compare. And then iske baad fir deployment and bahut kuch aur bhi aayega. Lekin ye basic machine learning wale ko itna pata hona chahiye minimum. This is your minimum scope. Itna to hona hi chahiye. Aisa nahi ho sakta ki bas mujhe ye karna hota hai.
Amrita, humne deployment karwaya hai kya?
Nahi, uska GCP ka project Manish Shankar will take. He will take with the GCP deployment.
ओके भैया, मुझे वही डाउट था कि हमने कंप्यूटर विजन में कोई डिप्लॉयमेंट करवाया था नहीं करवाया था.
सो ओके फाइन. सो यू कैन नॉट बी लाइक, नहीं मुझे तो बस इतना आता करना क्योंकि मैं तो मशीन लर्निंग इंजीनियर हूं. नहीं, स्टिल विद इन मशीन लर्निंग इंजीनियर आपको यहां से आगे कहानी पूरी पता होनी चाहिए. दिस मच यू मिनिमम नीड टू नो. सो यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज योर ऑब्जेक्ट. या विद टेंसरफ्लो इट हैज इट्स ओन फाइल सीके इज चेक पॉइंट्स बेसिकली. No, you can create different, there are different savers available these days. You can save it in a different formats if you want to. Okay, so Pickle is just one C type which Python provides. Okay, with SKLearn, I think there is also one model saver that you can use. Sorry? No, there is another file as well. You can generate another file type as well. It's not always pickle. Okay. I will look into it. I will tell you. I'm forgetting the name exactly. Okay. Okay. And then we have various networks. Okay. And within neural network, we have convolution, which works great with images or videos, basically. And now these are complex models, and it will take some time to understand how convolution works. What is the use of ReLU? What is pooling convolution plus ReLU? And again, why we flatten it? Why we fully connect it? Why softmax has been used? So that will take time. But see this, this is called feature learning. Many times, this is why neural networks are preferred, because they can automatically learn the features. This is why they are preferred, especially because of this part. This part still you can maybe achieve through some other models, but this is the part which kind of automates your work in life. And this is why we prefer it. Okay. So basically this is the whole idea, and there are different kind of learnings at different different levels within 7. It is trying to learn different things. Okay. And finally, it is trying to understand how it works. And basically we get a probability output. Softmax output is just probability. You get an argmax, basically that will return your index, and you can predict what is your exact output. Okay.
Highest probability.
Index of the highest probability, argmax. Okay, although this is convolution, but it's okay. So basically this is the trick, that this is a simple trick called convolution. Basically, which can detect or which can figure out if those features exist over there or not. That's it. Okay. So it is also called filter, which you might understand after a while, if you understand how kernel trick itself works, or any specialized filter when you apply. Okay. What is a filter in like signal processing, if you remember? Filter is what?
Filtering one signal.
Yeah, filtering or either kind of suppressing others and just taking one out. So that's what even convolution does. So in pictures, let's say at certain level, certain features are more important. So we need to get them. Then we need to aggregate them. And similarly, keep aggregating them. And hopefully we get a sense of what the picture is all about. Similarly, we have RNNs. Okay. So now this is just the script part. And basically here, the picture is bad actually. Yeah, no, I've tried like a lot of GIFs this time, okay, and GIFs. I went for GIFs on Google to find some good GIFs, but this GIF is not that good, is it?
No, it is.
Mm-hmm, that is, it should have been put in the whole thing. Okay, the idea is you put a sequence model, like a text. And NLP, when we will start, this sequence model matters. Okay, you put a sequence model one by one sequentially, and each neuron or each layer that you are right now seeing basically processes it, sends one as output to the next layer, and sends internally within the each layer as well. So basically a context is maintained. So if you do not do this, each word will appear like independently of each other. But you understand in sequence model, that's not the story. What happened before matters. Okay. Otherwise we will lose context.
Google search.
Or while you are typing something. That's where it is really important. And then we have autoencoders. Basically autoencoders are the unsupervised domain in this neural network. So far, whatever you have seen is mostly supervised. Okay. But autoencoder is trying to understand or trying to figure out. So autoencoders again have like really good utilities. Once it has been properly trained, it can be actually used to kill the noise. And basically, if there is any variation, it can figure out this is not the original thing. This much is the original reconstruction, and rest is noise. And as you can see, a good example that basically there is a spot, light spot. Okay. When you have these kind of lights, if you take a glossy surface, there would be, and if you take a picture. So this is again, this is which I am really showing you right now, is again a very good use case and case study. Okay, so how to reduce these kind of noises? Okay, so first you train on the regular cards. Is tarah ke hajaro lakho cards aap dikhao se, theek hai? Now it understands a card of this kind contains what? Okay, or what are the features? It learns it unsupervised. Now you start passing and let it recreate. So whatever is the noise, that will not get recreated. That's the idea. So that's how you can kill this in, and this is more or less unsupervised. Remember, but it requires a lot of data. It is not like 20 cards dikha ke ho jayega, nahi. It will require maybe thousands of such cards to understand what is the probabilistic idea behind it, how to reconstruct it, and then it can able to reconstruct it. Okay. And then there is the idea of a GANs. Okay. And where the idea is, you have two data points. Okay. Training and generation. Okay. So you start generating. So there is something called generator and discriminator. Okay. Generative adversarial. So generator is just generating fake images. And when it gets a lost signal back, so there would be a back propagation from the discriminator, it tries to correct itself. So the idea is discriminator knows what original data looks like. Okay. Generator starts with some random noise and basically initially it will generate some fake noise. Okay. Yeh aage jayega, it will travel forward. Ab yahan pe loss generate karega. Discriminator will say, no, you are wrong. You are wrong by 0.5. That loss goes back to the generator. Again, both are just neural networks. That's all they are. So generator will do what? It will change its weight till it can, let's say, produce something like 8 or and. It's basically reverse ampersand. Okay. Till it can produce correct reverse ampersand, and at some point there would be practically no difference. Okay, that is the whole idea. That at some point it would become so good, because it is trying to cut down loss, at some point it will become so good you will not be able to tell is it a generated model or is it the actual data. And again, this is a part of worry. GANs are again a very big issue these days. Yeah, Google Ansing, deepfakes, and so many applications, malicious applications have come. So people can put your face in pornographic videos, hate speeches and whatnot. And that is such a negative space right now. But again, these models have to be put open source so that the whole humanity can benefit. But unfortunately, such people are also available in the same world who can extract revenge on you. Okay, so text is just one thing. Text is one thing. Now think what happens when your video is there. Like, you understand, video is considered as a legal evidence. And if some doctor video, which you look like, it will literally look like you are in the video. It would be so hard for even courts to decide. You know, you understand what can be done. Okay, if some murderer commits a murder somewhere, but generates a fake video and posts it on Facebook and then shows it as proof, and Facebook timestamp will show that this person was there because it's a video of some place, but you morphed your video on someone's face, let's say. But let's say if it is so good, and koi verify to karne jayega nahi na, wo event ho gaya. Let's say it is some kind of a rock show. Wo rock show to hum recreate kar nahi sakte. Jo hi nahi hai ki aur bhi cameras honge, to aapke phone ka jo camera hai us bande ka jo tha. That guy took the video and posted it somewhere. You took the same video, and let's say there is no direct link to be proved between these two people. You just morphed your face over there. You killed someone at the very same time, but you also uploaded a video enjoying rock show. How a legal person will even, kaise isko argue kar paoge? This thing, video proof is actually considered actual proof. Agar main isko morph kar dunga kahin pe jaake aur thoda chalaki se dal do isko एक सोशल मीडिया पे और वहां पे टाइम स्टैम्प वगैरह अगर वो जब रीड करेंगे उन्हें दिखेगा हाँ सेम टाइम पे अपलोड किया था उसने, आपको कैसे कन्विक्ट कर लेगा वो फिर कोई? इवन आपके चाकू पे फिंगरप्रिंट निकला है, आपको कन्विक्ट नहीं किया जा सकता फिर. इट वुड बी एक्सट्रीमली हार्ड टू कन्विक्ट. सो एआई के लाइक बोथ एस्पेक्ट्स हैं, देयर आर ऑलवेज पॉजिटिव एस्पेक्ट्स, बट यू ऑल्सो हैव टू बी वेरी वरीड अबाउट द नेगेटिव एस्पेक्ट्स, व्हाट कैन गो रॉन्ग वेरी सीरियसली इफ अ पर्सन रियली गेट्स डिटरमाइंड एंड दीस थिंग्स स्टार्ट्स टू हैपन. There is a reference one, and then there's result. Maybe Putin can declare a war on US, and US preemptively strikes Russia. Right? This is even a bigger thing. Okay, general people are one thing. What about leaders? If something tension is going on, and one person comes on news like this, and that clip is circulated, and he's kind of declaring war on the other country, what if it literally starts a war? So these are the problems which you have to be worried about. Even you are excited about AI, but when you see these models, these powerful, and you can see this video on YouTube, you will not be able to tell much difference unless when the person moves really fast, then there is pixelization. If you are very stable now, there is no problem. Only when you are moving very fast, then only. What if in this way people start to fake their online interviews? I can pay someone and basically a software can morph my face on that. And if a person is very still and stable and he is coding, how will you know? Even if you keep ki chalo aap apna webcam on rakho, usse kya farak padega if we start morphing like this? So I'm just saying that possibilities like in both ways are really bad. And these are the transformers. So BERT and GPT, which basically we were talking about, these are the transformers. Ek language se dusre language mein ya text generation, even if you give in the same one, they can start to generate text. The way they have trained is they have just read practically anything available on internet or in English language. Okay. They have seen any combination of that word getting used or that kind of context getting used. And because of that much data, whatever they know in the correct context. So when you generate the data, it looks like it is a worldly knowledge, that it is actual knowledge. Some person has really read all of these books and everything. And that's why they can type with this much speed and this much accuracy. This is the whole idea basically. Okay. And if you want to see. तो जनरेटिव आपका रिग्रेशन हो गया, डिस्क्रिमिनेटिव आपके क्लासिफायर्स हो गए. ओके, वी कैन चूज और यू कैन आल्सो आस्क द क्वेश्चन, हु स्टार्स इन द मैट्रिक्स. ओके, नाउ इट हैज बीन बेसिकली ट्रेन्ड ऑन इट, सो इट इज नॉट. ओके, सो नाउ दीज आर द इंटर क्वेश्चन दैट यू ऑलरेडी नो. लेट्स से तो चलो इस पे तो ट्रस्ट थोड़ा कम कर सकते हैं. सो वन सेक, चूज एन एग्जाम्पल. So now it has shown like what kind of question you should usually ask. Okay. So you ask those kind of questions and basically you hit run over there. Choose an example. So, okay. Okay. So enter text. Okay. Why is it not working? Oh, one sec. Yeah, API is available. You can do a lot of things if you want to. Okay, sorry, here. That's what I was thinking. Where did it just go? Yeah, what do you want to ask? It has to be in questions or format. Kuch bhi puchna. Chandrayaan 2, I think the model is a bit old, but okay. Okay, let's see what it says. Okay, no, it is not the correct question. Basically, it needs to find that kind of question. Okay, so, okay, the problem is the context we have set for the matrix itself, right? Okay, let me change the context first.
How many stars are there in the world?
Okay, one sec. Who caught the shortest touchdown pass? Okay. Now this has not been copied from some text. It has been generated by it. The whole thing it has read from various news articles and it generates its own interpretation. So later you can come out with your own summaries and these summaries could be very much tailored to your style of language. So just in shorts, anyone knows what is in shorts? That 5-minute news kind of thing. Ab aap ye socho ki har news ko aapke language mein tailor kar sakte hain. Theek hai, ek standard news aa rahi hai CNN se, theek hai. Now but when you will listen or when you will read, it will be tailored in your language style. See the comfort. And for the other guy, it would be tailored to there. That is very much possible. That much what technology has already evolved. One second. Okay. Now, for the people who might know or who might not know already, we will be mostly focusing with the TensorFlow idea. Okay, so remember, you can go on this line as well, and most people will mostly drag you someday in this area itself. That fundamentally, when you go to GCP, Azure, AWS, and there are so many others, it is easy for convenience and it's easy prototyping. Whenever you go in this direction, remember, when you want to have more control, so this is the control, although I do not agree with why PyTorch is there. PyTorch should also be in this because PyTorch is allowing too much control now. Okay, so apart from Keras and Cafe, actually PyTorch should have been in this direction anyways. But all of these allow for much more control. So when you want to use fine tuning or you want to do something very personalized or specific, then you have to go this route. Okay. So Cafe 2, PyTorch or TensorFlow or Torch should be used. Okay. And if you just want to run fast, now Theano has been discontinued. If you just want to run, so run Cafe or Keras, or just run the AutoML or these kind of ML suits available. And then, but remember, these are easy prototyping. These might not work for specialized customized solutions. Then you will have to go this way. You can make maybe a dummy app in those kind of suits where, means like you put it in JavaScript and it codes in iOS and everything, okay, Android as well. So basic apps are bana paoge. Any specialized app cannot be made. You have to go in their native suits. So Android ke liye Android SDK chahiye hoga. Iske liye pura iOS development with Swift or whatever, Objective-C. You will not be able to make any, same thing will happen here as well. If you just want to try and test, you can just stick with Keras or Azure or these all kind of ML suits. But if you want to really make something on your own or personalized or customize it to the client's requirement, you have to start dealing with PyTorch, TensorFlow or Cafe 2 or DL4J. DL4J is in Java basically, okay? So you have to understand which direction you will have to, and depending on your company. So you can see, and again, remember PyTorch should not be here in this area. This is easy prototyping, POC prototype. So till you are doing all this, forget about PyTorch. You can use any of these. Once you start going in MVP, minimum viable product or final product, you have to go this direction. So that's why we take the approach with TensorFlow. We also teach some basic PyTorch and Keras, but Keras is practically the last thing I teach. And I personally don't enjoy much over there because there is not much to teach fundamentally. Okay. It's just, yeah, but no. Okay. So PyTorch is equally strong. PyTorch is different. First of all, you have to understand Keras is on top of TensorFlow. Fundamentally Keras does anything on its own. It's just a middleware library which takes all the instruction in a very simple way and loads it on TensorFlow to run.
No, CNTK also.
CNTK, yes. TensorFlow, CNTK, or so Keras is an API. Okay, same way when GCP does something, it is internally running TensorFlow, but it will not let you see. Okay, so for anything prototyping level, you can be here. Now PyTorch and TensorFlow are equally strong. Yeah, Keras plus TensorFlow is default now anyways. With TensorFlow 1.4 and or 1.3 and onwards, Keras is being shipped with the same installation. Earlier you had to separately install Keras. So first you will install TensorFlow, then Keras. Nowadays you just install TensorFlow, Keras gets installed immediately. Okay. One sec. Kisi ko agar interest hai, toh ye ek slide hai. Ye एक काफी बड़े मॉडल के लिए या काफी बड़े साइकिल को इफ समवन वांट्स टू रियली अंडरस्टैंड ज़ूम इन हो पाएगा क्या ये तो मैक्सिमम पे चल रहा है ना देखते हैं इस पे होगा कि नहीं ओके नहीं बट ये ब्रेक करेगा ना चलो इतना ठीक है नहीं नहीं दिस इज ऑल राइट ओके नाउ यहां पे इट विल मैटर व्हाट काइंड ऑफ यू सिस्टम यू हैव डू यू हैव एसडीएस और क्लाउड और जस्ट क्लाउड और एसएसडी then what kind of ETL you are running or what kind of metadata tagging you are doing. But then if it is a distributed system, is it Hadoop or Spark data lakes? If you have done archiving, then how it has been done on tape or on your hard disk or your SSDs, then ML and DL is just like this, one block. This is why most of the questions are from this one. And then once you are done, then the insights are there. which companies, which insights could still be presented through visualization tools. Okay. So ML and DL is just one module, and rest everything, and most of the companies I see is interested in, apart from that module, they're interested in everything else. Okay. People who have already done the course, they might already have these books. For few people who are new to this course, I will just refer these courses and these books. And I will always upload. I always have a habit of uploading some good books. So start finding some good courses and some books to get started with. And let's take a break. And after a break, let's start discussing something about NLP today. Okay. देखना पड़ेगा
एक वीकेंड तो छुट्टी आएगा
ना दिवाली में रहेगा मे बी Okay, guys, so we are back, and now we are going to start some parts of NLP. Okay. What does NLP mean? Coding? No. Okay. So if you remember now, when LSTM or GRU is there, what you will feed it? That's the question, right? Words नहीं feed कर पाओगे ना उसको?
तो sparse matrix
ही. हाँ, sparse matrix करोगे, लेकिन sparse matrix में value क्या होगा? हाँ, तो वही तो वो क्या है? वो all the pre-processing step. You have to understand. Like देखो, CV में क्या पढ़ाया मैंने आपको उतने दिन? Apart from SSD मैंने और क्या ही पढ़ाया? सब कुछ बताया traditional CV में. तो यहाँ पे भी वही होगा. Traditionally होगा क्या? Once you understand what to do with that text. Then you can take GRUs, RNNs, LSTM, whatever is your choice. And again, pre-trained model mil jayenge. SSD mein bhi kya hua? Maine aapko dikhaya na sab kuch. Aapko ye bhi dikhaya ki pre-trained model kahan se uthane. Last mein dekho yaar, ye 300, 400 ME ke models majaat nahi hai. Inko train karne mein Google ne agar ek mahina lagaya na, unke paas pura server farm hai, tab ek mahina laga tha. Aapko 2-4 saal lag sakte hain aapke ek GPU pe karte ka. Haan. Nahi, aap apne graphics card bhi khareed lo na, aapke bijli ke bill aayenge aise aise. तो आप वो कर भी नहीं पाओगे. हम एक्सपेक्ट भी नहीं कर रहे कि ऐसा होने वाला भी है, मजाक में भी. तो एट सम पॉइंट आई विल अगेन गिव यू कि नहीं, दीज आर स्टैंडर्ड ट्रांसफॉर्मर लाइक BERT हो गया, GPT-2 है, और देयर वुड बी सम अदर एज वेल व्हिच आई विल इंट्रोड्यूस. एंड एट सम पॉइंट आई विल मेक श्योर दैट यू आर एबल टू फीड द डेटा इन दिस वन करेक्टली. और अगेन यू कैन टेक इट इन सम एग्जांपल्स. आई विल टेक ए वर्ड टू वेक एंड आई विल फीड इट इन RNN एंड LSTM. बट आप भी जानते हो वो स्टेट ऑफ द आर्ट तो हो नहीं सकता एकदम से. ठीक है, वो डमी एग्जांपल इज वेरी नाइस, बट यू अंडरस्टैंड दैट इज नॉट गोना ब्रेक एनी रिकॉर्ड्स. सो कल किसी कंपनी एक्चुअल यूज केस में जब करोगे तो मोस्टली क्या करोगे, यू विल टेक ए ओपन सोर्स मॉडल, यू विल रिटेन इट विद योर डेटा एंड यू विल पुट इट इन योर प्रोडक्शन. दैट्स ऑल यू आर गोना डू. ओके, ज्ञान का तो वही देखने लगे, वही है ना, करंट बैच में एक्टिव लोग कितने हैं, वही तो इश्यू. ज्ञान का करना है और वो पाइटॉर्च का स्पेशली कोड है. ठीक है, देखते हैं क्या कर सकते हैं उसके लिए भी. Okay, fine. Okay, NLP. Sorry, first I should be here actually. Okay, fundamental. Let's start with the fundamentals. What does NLP stands for?
Natural language.
Okay, weird. Okay, it's not working that well.
Made for a open loop. Sensitivity.
नहीं, बट थोड़े से पहले तो बड़ा अच्छा वर्क कर रहा था, देखते हैं. देखो कहीं कहीं पे छूट जाता है ऐसे, जब वर्क करता है तो बड़ा अच्छा ही करता है. ओके, वियर्ड. ओके, natural language processing. Okay, what, okay, let's start with each word prep. Natural language, what does it means? What, sorry, okay, what do we speak? Okay, what are the properties of a natural language, NLP or natural language? What is the property?
Subject
as in what sense you said?
It should have a context, meaning.
Context and meaning. Nice. Fine. Anything else? Some kind of structure, some kind of grammar? Grammar, actually, that framework thing which you are saying is grammar. That's what is grammar. It's a kind of a framework. Intent, okay, fine. Anything else? With NLP, what are the other properties?
Sentiment.
ओके, फाइन. वह इंटेंट बोल दिया तो हो गया ना, छोड़ो. वन थिंग व्हिच पीपल डू नॉट लाइक टू एडमिट, एम्बिगुअस. इट्स नॉट क्लियर लाइक ए कंप्यूटर प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज. कंप्यूटर प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज इज क्रिस्टल क्लियर. व्हाट एवर यू हैव टू डू, यू हैव टू डिफाइन एज इट इज, एंड इट डजंट डेविएट्स. लैंग्वेज इज हाईली एम्बिगुअस, एग्री? एंड दैट्स वेयर द प्रॉब्लम इज. इफ इट वॉज कंप्लीटली लॉजिकल, इट वुड हैव बीन ए इजियर प्रॉब्लम टू सॉल्व. problem is the ambiguity or errors or the problem stop noises and everything. Okay, what are ambiguities really? Like, okay, any example of language ambiguity that, okay, and? Nahi, agar general example hi pooch leta, let's ask simple examples. In language, what are the confusing things or what are the ambiguous things that I'm saying that makes it very hard? Nice, very nice. That's a very good example. Fishermen went to bank. Now, bank could be the river side. Okay, that is called bank. Or it could be the institute, monetary institute. ठीक है ना, आपका पैसे का भी काम हो सकता है. लेकिन there is a high contextual value कि नहीं, अगर वो fishing करने गया होगा तो bank पे जाएगा ना. Now it's a very tricky problem. And if I do not have the correct context, अगर किसी ने ऐसा एक line दे दिया, तो almost 50-50% लगता है कि दोनों हो सकते हैं. How do I know it is? They are. Okay. How do I know which one is correct? Ambiguity, right? What other kind of ambiguity I deal with in NLP? You guys deal it with regularly. You just do not realize it right now.
Punctuations.
Very good. You change a punctuation or a drop a punctuation, it means something else. It really.
Right. Like for another example, like but I told you that chor ko pakdo mat jaane do, the chor ko pakdo, comma, mat jaane do, chor ko pakdo mat, fir comma mat jaane do.
Yeah, so you see, just by putting different commas, comma at a different place, I can change the whole meaning. It has just completely different implications. Okay, so an English professor was teaching in a class, and basically he says that a double negative makes a positive. Okay. But there is no example of a double positive making a negative. It's not happening. Someone at the back of the class says, yeah, right. Did you guys get the joke? Now, yeah, right. Both are positives. But the way you said it made it a very negative thing. So he was just teaching about the written part, but the way you say it also matters. Now, right now, I'm not going to take in the speech part. Okay, don't worry. But just telling you the ambiguity issue. Even if I define a grammatical rule, it's very easy to find a problem with it, because then the issue is tone, right? What kind of tone am I using? Sarcasm. Okay, how do you detect sarcasm? How humans can detect sarcasm?
Facial expression.
That's one.
Tone.
Because you can detect sarcasm online as well.
Tonality.
One sec. Let me just reduce the volume. Oh my God. Okay. But you can also detect sarcasm online. So over there you cannot see the other person. Then context. Out of context, ja ke aapne kuch bol diya hoga. Yeah, you might have reversed the whole meaning all of a sudden. I was talking in some sense, and then you just reverse the meaning. It might be sarcasm. And verbally, tone. Phone pe kaise pata chalega? Context is there, no doubt. But if you are listening to someone, tone is again a thing. The way I say things matters. Now you start seeing the problem. More modalities I am including, language can become even more confusing. Okay, it can. There is a variable, there is a multi use of same word. In a different context, it can become different ideas, like bank. Or beer, you understand the problem, right? So what is the first problem with beer? Yeah,
it's spelling.
Now there are two problems with beer. I have to press
it's spelling, yeah. And the meaning also.
This is the speaking problem. Okay, but problem could still be if beer is noun or a verb. You understand when it's noun, what it is, and what is it when it's verb. Bear has two meanings, and contextually as well. If I say this is a bear market, then what does it mean? I just said this is a bear market. What do I mean? Go for it. Context matters, but okay, just take your guesses now. Kya ho sakta iska meaning?
Nothing in this
market. Nahi, bear, you understand what bear market means, right? In stock terms, bear market means you are in downfall. और अगर एक 5 साल के बच्चे को ये बोलते तो बस वो बेयर का मार्केट है. सी कॉन्टेक्स्ट मैटर. इफ आई जस्ट फ्लिप द कॉन्टेक्स्ट और इफ आई डू नॉट टेल यू द कॉन्टेक्स्ट यू विल स्टिल एंड दिस इज द पार्ट एवरीवन टॉक्स अबाउट गुड पार्ट्स ऑफ एनएलपी स्ट्रक्चर दिस ब्ला ब्ला ब्ला. नो वन सेज इट इज एम्बिगुअस एंड दैट इज वेयर यू फेल. दैट इज वेयर सिस्टम्स एनएलपी सिस्टम्स और व्हाटएवर सिस्टम वी डिजाइन स्टार्ट्स टू फेल. How to take care of ambiguities? Ambiguities as cause of humans' imperfection. Okay, because we could have come up with different words, but maybe we got lazy or maybe there was conflict. These two words came at the same point at different geographical reasons. And when people came together, they were like, okay, fine. Their spellings are different. Just keep it the same. No, but the problem is computers do not think like that. Each word needs to have a separate representation. That's the fundamental issue. Okay, so you might have worked on, I guess all of you have worked on machine learning projects or deep learning projects already. What kind of data have you dealt with? Tell me.
Numerical
text data. How do you handle text data?
Bag of words
approach, okay, very simple approach. Any other approach? TF-IDF, okay, anything else? Oh, what is TF-IDF exactly? Okay. What do you get from TF-IDF? Means like those numbers are representative of what?
Yeah, these are basically the weights of the word.
Occurrence of the word
frequency.
That is
the frequency.
Basically, it's the inverse frequency. That's all it is. So, okay, what does zero means over there and what you understand? TF-IDF will be 0 to 1.
Nice. Zero means natural. It depends on the lower occurrences, natural.
Okay. If it is exactly zero, then what it means?
I mean, like
the frequency has not happened. You have to understand.
Any kind of frequently occurring words which doesn't make any sense, like so those can be removed.
Okay, now zero can be achieved two ways. Just let me. We will have the class on TF-IDF. Don't worry. But people who already know, that's a great thing. What is the formula of TF-IDF? Let's take the 2-1 because of the information theory problem. Arey yaar, kya ho raha hai isko aaj? Okay, the pen is again causing some issues. Okay, log capital N IDF. Okay, inverse document frequency. Make sense? This is the equation. Now zero ko ab do tarah se achieve kar sakte hain. Pe how? TF is zero. Occurrence nahi hai. Or वो क्या होगा जब हर वर्ड हर जगह वो रिपीट हुआ है तो इज दी और दी विच प्रैक्टिकली गेट्स रिपीटेड एज मेनी टाइम्स इफ एन एंड आईडीएफ इक्वल बिकम्स इक्वल देन बेसिकली इट विल बिकम लॉग वन एंड दैट विल आल्सो गिव यू जीरो. सो दोनों तरह से जीरो अचीव हो सकते हैं. ईदर इट हैज नेवर सीन दैट सो टीएफ टर्म विल बिकम जीरो और इट हैज सीन जस्ट टू मेनी टाइम्स एंड इट फील्स लाइक अ कॉमन वर्ड. बट इतना याद रखना उस जीरो को यूजली आप इग्नोर कर रहे हो. इसका मतलब ये होता है इट इज डजंट मींस इट्स अ वेरी हाई रेटेड वर्ड. वैल्यू इज गोइंग क्लोज टू वन आर द हाईएस्ट रेटेड. नाउ अगेन डिफरेंट ट्रिक्स आर अवेलेबल टू अचीव वन. ओके फाइन वी विल कम ऑन TF-IDF बिकॉज दैट्स अगेन अ वेरी गुड स्टैटिस्टिकल टेक्निक दैट वी नीड टू स्टडी. ओके फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल सो आवर टॉपिक वॉज ओके फाइन यू डू ऑल दिस. ओके वाई वी डू ऑल दिस.
More into
the document. Okay. Number the fundamental problem is any matrix multiplication is not going to work on text. First of all, everything what you said is correct, but there is a much simpler explanation. It cannot work on text unless you are doing decision tree where was calculation hota hai. Wahan pe bhi frequency honi chahiye, right? If there is no frequency, you cannot have probability and entropy calculations. That's the problem. Text pe to work hi nahi kar sakta na. All the things have to be converted to numbers at the end of the day. Last may, if you break down something into numpy, it has to be either floating point or integers at the end of the day. Uske bilao to nahi ho raha hai na. Sara, whatever you have studied, you have seen, everything is math fundamentally. So, in words ko, you have to convert them to numbers. Now, the problem is how? And this problem has been for like 50, 60 years. there has been some good books on statistical nature of NLP, and I will be sharing those books. If you find some time, do read them. Basically, it's a big area of research. How to basically represent words? What kind of space and how do you really want to represent? Okay, first, let's talk about even a simpler concept, much, much simpler concept. Let's say if you have the NLP data, how is it really presented to an ML algorithm? If it's a supervised example. But how would you present? Okay, up to what is your expectation? Okay, let's say if you have a numeric data, how do you present this numeric data? Feature space. Makes sense. So you have your x1s and x2 till xn, right? Then you might have a y. Makes sense? NLP data mein kaise karoge? Agar maine aapko ek email de diya. What is this n?
Number of words.
Number of unique words. Okay. Maybe you might have to remove stop words and noise words or redundant words, okay? Or unstandardized words, okay? Fine. Sorry?
Stemming
as well. Okay. So how will we construct this data set? Forget about any advanced technique. Let's just go as basic as you can. How this entry data set will look like?
Kind of clustering, like similar words will be clustered together.
नहीं, अभी entry कर रहा हूँ data का. किसी भी algo में enter जब कर रहे होगे. Okay, so when I will be entering this data, how will you? Because look, it is expecting a matrix inside, rows and columns. Now I am giving you an email. ठीक है? I gave you an email. How would you handle this? This is the question. Okay, fine. Let's start with the very basic approach. Let's start with the count. What you will do is, let's say you have let. Okay, so what are these x1, x2, xn here on the top now? What are these features?
Words.
Let's say we start canonically or alphabetically. So words appearing from A will appear first, then with B, C, D till Z, and it would be a sparse matrix. What is sparse matrix really? Sorry?
Lot of zeros.
Majorities are basically zeros. Why? Because, okay, and okay, fine. This would be column. What would be the row? What is the whole row?
One
email or one word object. वर्ड ऑब्जेक्ट या अच्छा ऐसा समझो मान लेते हैं एक ईमेल में या डॉक वन में अब क्वेश्चन हो रहा है ये वर्ड रिपीट हुआ कि नहीं लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द बेसिक काउंटिंग प्रोसेस इफ ए इज देयर हाउ मेनी टाइम्स लेट्स से ए और व्हाटएवर द वर्ड इज वी आर गोइंग वर्ड बाय वर्ड नॉट लेटर बाय लेटर सो 3 टाइम्स बी हैज नॉट बीन रिपीटेड एंड मोस्ट ऑफ द नंबर्स और वर्ड्स विल नॉट बी देयर ठीक है सो मोस्ट विल बी जीरो कहीं कहीं पे बीच में वन टू समथिंग विल कम ओके एंड लेट्स से एट द एंड यू हैव सेंटिमेंट और मे बी क्लासिफिकेशन इट इज अ काइंड ऑफ ईमेल इट इज काइंड ऑफ अ वर्क ईमेल इट इज काइंड ऑफ अ प्रमोशन ठीक है मान लो जैसे जीमेल में कैटेगरीज आती हैं सो कैन यू टेक 10,000 ऑफ योर ईमेल्स एंड मैनुअली नॉट मैनुअली सॉरी माय बैड कैन यू ट्रेन योर एल्गो ऑन लेट्स से ऑन दोस क्लासिफिकेशन And can you make sure that same thing happens with your new emails? So just I'm telling you, and I okay. So I'm not sure how the common link will work now. Okay, there is something called Enron email dataset, very famous. Okay, I want you to download this dataset. Okay, and we will have to work on this. Either do it from Kaggle or directly from the CMU website. Okay. So you can find the May 7 version, 423, tarred and zipped. Okay, just download it, unzip it, and check the CSVs. That's all your task is for today. That's all you have to do. Okay, these are just emails. So Enron was a company which basically was found in lot of illegal activities, and basically it went down back in 2000, close to 2000. I'm forgetting when it happened. Okay, so but oh. After the case and everything was over, so all of their email was collected by government, And then it was given to CMU and some other universities and they open sourced it. So all of the real emails are available to us. And these are again official emails, most of them. So it's a very good data set. Haan, it's a jo bhi hai, had 20 saal purana, but it is. And once you open it, you will see a lot of problems in email and we will keep on discussing. So just us time mein when we were doing neural networks and OpenCV and these things, there were some data sets I always used to tell. This will be one of the first starting data sets you have to deal with. Okay, that's email classification we call can call it. Can you classify your emails incoming or this email into, let's say 6-7 categories defined by us. Simple classification, because classification sabse pehle samjhte hai logon ko. Uske baad hum fir text generation aur sab ki baat karenge ki how to generate text. Let's start with the basic classification. Can you maybe separate the databases with work and maybe personal or kuch bhi hum log hi define karenge 4-5 categories. And based on that, can we make it work? That would be our task, one of the projects that we will undertake. Okay, please download it. It would be helpful and go through the whole Enron data set. It would be really helpful for you guys. And once you will go, you will see a lot of problems. Okay, emails mein what kind of problems we can run into?
Spam,
very good. Anything else? Promotion, nice. पर वही करना है यू हैव टू सेपरेट देम ओके एज अ टेक्सचुअल फैक्टर व्हाट कैन गो रॉन्ग
ओके वो कितने बार उसका
सब्जेक्ट
कितने बार सब्जेक्ट नहीं होता
आई एम वरीड अबाउट द टेक्सचुअल प्रॉब्लम व्हाट आर द प्रॉब्लम्स इन ईमेल नाउ ये 99 का ईमेल है तो इसमें पिक्चर्स नहीं आएंगे थैंकफुली अभी के टाइम में तो पिक्चर्स पॉपअप हो जाते हैं उसमें तो वो इश्यूज नहीं है आपको पिक्चर्स नहीं मिल रहे गलती से इसमें ऑल ऑफ देम आर प्योर टेक्स्ट तो इट्स अ क्लासिक एनएलपी स्टडी बट अगेन सेम प्रॉब्लम आई एम आस्किंग एज अ टेक्स्ट अच्छा व्हाट आर द प्रॉब्लम्स व्हेन यू सी एन ईमेल व्हाट डू यू थिंक व्हेन यू विल ट्राई टू प्रोसेस इट व्हाट कैन गो रॉन्ग
हेलो हेलो
स्माइली कॉलन्स स्टिल पीपल आउट ऑफ कॉन्टेक्स्ट गुड एंड वन थिंग आई विल टेल यू यू इसके लिए देखना पड़ता है इसको चेन मेल्स big problem they destroy the context either someone else one person is destroying the whole chainmail context usne galti se kuch aur likh diya chalo is week par picnic chalte hain hota hai na log karte rehte hain dhyan nahi hota hai type enron mein aise data milte hain he last 20 emails are about some serious stuff and then someone is asking picnic I'm like ye kya hua you will realize this is a big problem it is a big decision should you cut out the chainmail part Should you just keep the active body? क्योंकि पूरी मेल में तो चेन मेल में देखो जी मेल में इफ आई ओपन ए चेन मेल व्हाट विल हैपन पूरी चीज निकल आएगी पूरा ट्री आता है ट्री स्ट्रक्चर में दिखाते हैं ये मेल इस टाइम पे हुआ इस टाइम पे अब दिस इज अ बिग डिसीजन शुड यू कंसिडर द होल चेन मेल और यू शुड यू कंसिडर जस्ट द एक्टिव मेल यही प्रॉब्लम है अब तो मैनुअली करोगे अब दिस इज द होल ब्यूटी ऑफ डीप लर्निंग ऐसे क्या करते हैं तो मैनुअली रूल्स यू वुड हैव ट्राई टू मेक सम रूल्स राइट Now you cannot do manually. This is such a big data set for you because the text data 423 MB is not going to be small. ठीक है ना 423 MB की notepad files अगर आपने खोलने से हाँ zipped है you 423 even if it was original size imagine notepad files of 423 आपको तुरंत समझ में आएगा कि ये problem है. You will realize you cannot have this approach of manually tinkering things after a while. And you will start to look in directions of unsupervised algorithms and deep learning after a while. Super, जो आपकी classical machine learning है ना, after a while it's not going to work that great. Maybe with combination of deep neural networks, you can use SVM or something for final classification. That is a good approach. You can maybe extract the feature vectors, and on feature vectors पे you can do the classification. But initially you cannot start with a normal machine learning algo. It's not going to work. Now it doesn't have those categories printed out. So you might have to run some clustering algorithm first. इसमें ऐसा नहीं है इसमें बस ईमेल है just email है. But if you run some clustering algorithms, you will be able to see there are different clusterings. Now you will have to inspect each cluster. हाँ वो उस cluster का mail पढ़ना पड़ेगा खुद जाके हाँ वो जाके पढ़ो उसके बाद आप उस cluster को name करो ठीक है Now इसके बाद क्या कर सकते हो आप इस data को supervise convert कर सकते हो Once I have The hope is if you have done the correct clustering. Nee, haan, You can use DBScan or some advanced density based.
In the clustering, it is just that gaming. In the clusters, we define
those
5 clusters, it is coming that we name that cluster. That means customers are there who buy.
Nee, but here you will have to look the email. Na? First of all, you do not know anything about the emails. You do not even know how many kinds of emails can be there. So yahan pe thoda sa smartly karna padega. You have to apply hierarchical or DB scans to actually figure out which clustering technique you might be. Ab yahan pe multiple apply karo. DB scans, I am telling you just in advance, it might give you really good results. Okay. DB scan. It's a density based scan. Okay. So try that, and we will keep using this Enron dataset again and again with different problems, and we will try to perform a lot of operations on this so that it will serve as a very good benchmark to go forward. Now there are n number of data sets. I'm not targeting your net saying. Problem with deep neural network is the bigger the data set, it leads to more computational time. And because we are using Google Colab, there would be limitations. We cannot just expand our work into any direction. Okay. So it's a good learning tool, and I want you guys to definitely download it and start looking into it. Okay. No, so actually I was telling him. So you guys have not done the whole deep learning thing, right? So you will not, might not be able to pull this immediately. Only two of here and two online have done the whole deep learning thing already. So these guys will go in depth and do all kinds of deep learning. You guys will have to wait a bit till you finish deep learning, at least the basic module of deep learning. Till we finish LSTM RNNs, you will not be able to do much with it. That's the problem right now, okay? Okay, so of course I will tell you the problem statement, and you are more than welcome to take a swing at it, no problem. But you will need to learn for LSTM, RNNs, how all of these things work, and where these will be extremely helpful. Okay. All right. Now, people might get a sense, okay, this is a sparse data set. Now, this is a very elemental idea we have just started with. Sorry? Yeah. So while training, when you construct this, you try to find any unique word in the whole corpus, not the email, whole corpus. Okay, let me define it. What corpus is?
What if it's very?
हाँ, तो जाए, तो that's why the NLP, इसलिए तो इतने last में पढ़ा रहे हैं. Images से भी ज़्यादा problem NLP है. Yes, it is. First, you if you remember. A single cell of LSTM consists 6 gates. I have told you it's a heavy thing. Now you are putting this kind of data set here, which, as you rightly identified, if a corpus is big or it contains varied words, it can really become a massive sparse matrix. So yes, that's the problem. NLP, this is why NLP training is even harder than images. If you have massive data set like Google's, which have practically scanned every document on internet, they can train, but even on their server farms, it can take months. Their server farms. You can forget about your little GPU. That's not going to even work here. We will be mostly using pre-trained models. So imagine if Google is taking months to train this, of course it's like heavier model than the, it's a complicated problem than CV. You have to understand this. CV is still an easier problem these days. NLP is still a much, much worse problem. And what? No, there are two reasons. Scope is there. There are two reasons. Only 30% of the data on an average, which is captured, is structured data. 70% is unstructured, and most of the data falls in the NLP category. Yes. So, agar ek simply aap aise bhi maths karoge, to aapko samjhega ki is zone mein jyada jobs aane wali, right? Wo to simple ek random pick se bhi aap bata sakte ho ki isme jyada jobs honge. Sorry? What, theek hai, that is getting generated, no doubt. Images and videos are also getting generated. Text is also getting generated. The problem is with structure. There are so many great approaches already we have. Even if you have good data, SVM can outperform so many technologies so fast, right? You do not even need to think about neural networks first. Unstructured mein kya ho pa aapke paas? Yes, that's the worst problem. It is much used than structured. So if you do not have the correct technologies or correct first, okay, forget about the actual classification tool. How do you represent the data correctly matters a lot. Okay, think. Only count matters. Just think. Today class is just about a proper discussion. Do you think only count matters of words at the end of the day? Break matters.
No.
Count, break, and context matter. How would you capture context all of a sudden? Okay. Now let's say I take a word called technology. And context might, okay, this pen is really giving me.
Click on the brush.
Okay, let me check.
Click on the brush.
Should I select something else? Okay, let me try. Thanks. Okay, this is the issue. Okay. So let's say, or an AR. No, same. It is still breaking. It is not doing that worse, but it is breaking. Okay, let's say technology and science are related. How much? Similarity if between 0 to 1, if I tell you to find.
The difference is different.
Sorry?
Technology is more.
No, no. Okay, that's fine. But in a general sentence, if I say science and technology, do you feel that they are very different from each other? No, right? But you could find a document. Agar uspe sirf count ka agar pura maths karoge, to you will find maybe science and technology are used in a very different terms. You could find a document. But a general global knowledge tells you what. Ab yahi pe puri problem hai. With images, I can try to understand something locally, okay? But with English language or any natural language, there is a general information you also need to have. Like the bank problem, which he just told. Fisherman went to bank. It's a very big problem. Now, this general sense, we take it very granted in our lives. Yeah, okay, you should know this. The machine doesn't know anything. It doesn't understand anything. Now, the problem is maybe locally, it looks like there is a significant difference between science and technology. Let's say for your one document. But globally, aisa kuch nahi hota. Globally, science and technology are very, very close related words. But globally, dekho, it's a supervised example so far. But if it has never seen that kind of example, how can it learn that? It can't. Neural network ho ya kuch bhi ho, it doesn't matter. It has, if it has never seen those kind of repetition or context, of course it can't. And this is where Google and these guys are getting advantage. They have scoured the whole internet technically. They have seen as many repetition, as many users of science and technology together and separate to tell between 0 to 1, where should we place science and technology? I will tell you in Word2Vec how it has been done exactly. It's a, basically Word2Vec is a two-layered neural network, which groups the correct things with certain numbers or value or vectors actually. So initially you will fight for a single number for each word, right? Later, you will realize a single word might require a vector representation itself. See where we are going. First, you start with some count. It's a simple idea. These are bag of word approaches that we will also start with. Then you are like TF IDF. Nahi yaar, document mein kitni importance hai? Between 0 to 1, some floating point. After a while, you will realize all of this doesn't really matter. We need to create a much higher dimension space. Okay. Over there, each word needs to be placed and wahan pe cluster karna padega. This is how I'm going to build up. I'm going to start from the next classes with very few simple approaches. Okay? Initially, frequency count will just matter. That will be more than enough for you. Then you will realize frequency count doesn't mean anything. If the document is written in a way, then significance in a document requires. Okay? TF-IDF will come in the play. LDA latent digital allocation will come in play. There is Likert-Chivitin coefficient or distance coefficient, I'm forgetting the name, that will come. How much two words are different and what is this? Yeah, cosine similarity and these things will come. But even after a while, you will realize it is just not on one axis. A word could have meaning in multiple axes. And this is where GloVe or Word2Vec representations come to play. So right now, okay, now I will just make this diagram slightly complicated for you. Imagine rather than using a single number here, you take a vector which is of 128 length.
128?
Length.
Length.
Means it contains 128 floating points. So it is already a two-dimensional thing. Now I pushed it into a three-dimensional. Because each cell that you were putting it with one number, whatever it was, I just replaced it with 128 feature vectors. So I'm just saying, maybe, no, in Word2Vec, you can change it. 512 feature vectors can also be achieved. But remember, you increase your features, you pay the penalty with computation. No, computation, it will just take more time to train. Heavier value you put, heavier data you give to neural network, it takes more time. Any algorithm, it's just not neural network. Any algorithm will take more time. Okay, so now what we are saying is, let's imagine a world.
But at the time of training, we have to pay.
Sorry?
I mean, at the time of training, we have to pay for that.
Yes. That design decision has to be made by you. Okay, so let's now imagine there is a world, okay? Yaar, ye to ajeeb hi ho raha hai. Not
working.
Okay, hold on. Maybe this might work. Wow. Paint me sure as such. Okay. Okay, this is the point. This is called dog. You understand, maybe in two axes you cannot represent dog. So ek main aapko ek representation ka tarika batata hu ki how you represent multidimensional data. You make a point and you represent thin lines around it. What are these thin lines? Anyone knows? Okay. Dekho, ab graphically ek limitation aa chuki hai hamare paas. Do ya teen axis se zyada I cannot show you, right? Okay, now imagine this is a point and this info or this length signifies the value of x. This length signifies the value x, y, z. ठीक है? अब इसको अगर एक स्मार्ट वे में लिखना था तो ऐसे भी लिख सकते हैं. ठीक है? So अगर मुझे थोड़े ज्यादा पॉइंट दिखाने का शौक हुआ तो ये आप ऐसे समझो, डॉग को आप 128 लेंथ में 128 डायमेंशन में बता रहे हो. अर्लियर डॉग वॉज जस्ट लाइक 3, 2 और 0.1 और सम वैल्यू, राइट? After a while, you will realize all of that will not suffice. As you go with a deeper model, these single numbers do not matter. So what you start to do, in each you put a feature vector. Abhi tak you were thinking it as a single point. Theek hai? Start thinking it as high dimensional feature vector. Theek hai? Now, here in higher dimension, the idea is, can I figure out if this is a dog? I'm just trying to draw some things for you. And let's use another color. This is a cat. How similar they are. Now, if you look species wise, they are very different. If you see their purpose, they are very similar. Got it? Species, they are two different species. One is from wolf family, one is from cat family. Okay? But purpose is they are pets. The purpose of them is we rely them for company, enjoyment, and kind of a mental pleasure. Like, acha lagta na when you pet your dogs and stuff. Housekeeping. Really? They do housekeeping? I didn't know. Itne smart dog ho to bhej dena mere ghar mein. They will clean my home. And I understood. Basically, kyunki wo ganda karte hain, to aapko clean karna padega baith ke pura ghar. Okay, whatever. You got the sense? It can be highly different in one sense, but it could be very similar in the other sense. Now, which sense matters? That is dependent on context. This is why, because once people started capturing context, they understood, bhai, tumhare one count ka koi meaning nahi hai yahan pe. I am dealing with context, and in this context, dog is very close to cat. Maybe in your document, cat has been just repeated more. Iska matlab ye thoda hota hai, cat is more important now. In that context, dog and cat both are very equally plausible. This is the ambiguity part. There are so many contexts, and these contexts, when you change the context, the value of the outcome can also change. Now, which one to choose, you do not know. You don't have the control, and you do not want to have the control, otherwise it will become a hand engineering. You want to give this feature space or a representation of this data to the neural network and let neural network do the work. That's the target. So from coming week, we are going to start with very simple models. First, we will start with noise removal, stemming, and some processes. Then we will look at continuous word, bag of words for n-grams, skip-grams. Then we will go for statistical modeling, LDA, TF-IDF, distance coefficients, cosine coefficients, okay? And slowly we will build, we will build towards a Word2Vec. And at the end, there would be few projects, but I'm fearing that people who do not have an in-depth knowledge of neural networks as of now, they might not be able to participate immediately. But that project will be valid for you. As you are learning neural network, you can keep working sideline on you. So you will not have the pressure of submission. The guys who have done it, they will have the pressure of submission by some deadline. Usually I allow 2 weeks, 15 days max, okay? Okay guys, so let's stop the class for today. Neural network, deep learning. Okay. CV, for you guys, CV would be last. Okay, any questions? Otherwise, we can meet coming week and we can... Saturday, Sunday, yes. Anything? Okay, guys, so I'm finishing up the session and...